following is a WeTV Sports production. Good evening and welcome back to Kingsville Arena. And I say welcome back because we were here last night, Steve Pronger.
It doesn't seem like I left, Mark. What a game last night if you were watching on WeTV.
What a game. Absolutely. It was just not the game I expected, not the score I expected. And hopefully tonight we're going to see a little bit of a different production.
Absolutely. Two very good hockey clubs here, the two top teams in the Greater Metro Hockey League. Mark, we have game five here. And as you were telling me before the game, it's really down to the best two out of three
best
at this point.
It's a best of seven, but right, it's down to three games. Each team has won and lost a game in each other's barn. So a rather interesting breakdown for this. You'd think that the home ice would really have an effect on things, but it doesn't seem to right now. So they've had success and they've not had success. So we're going to see what happens here at the Kingsville Arena Complex. Game five, Tottenham Steam and the Kingsville Kings.
Yeah, Mark, so really Tottenham unfortunately lost a game last night, tying up with the Kingsville Kings. They need to do certain things tonight to stay in this. And one of the things that Tottenham Steam really have to focus on, and there you see it, discipline. We didn't see a very disciplined game last night from the Tottenham Steam for sure. They need to keep themselves out of the box and in a good mental frame of mind. They need to get shots on net. They didn't get enough shots on Jan Pešek last night, only one goal in net. And really, tonight, they need to play smart before they play hard. Now, people say, well, playing hard, you have to play hard. Sure, but you have to make plays and well-thought-out plays. You can't get frustrated. Got to stay in the game mentally and play smart. Now, for the Kingsville Kings, of course, they just really have to stick to the game plan, Mark.
Last night's game plan was a very good one.
Right. They've scored nine goals in the last two games against the Tottenham Steam's three, so they need to stick to, you know, just keep doing what they're doing, but also they need to stay out of the box. We've seen Matt Fisher with a tremendous goal last night, a great shot for a goal. This kid can score. They have to not give him those chances on the power play. And really, Tottenham Steam's going to be coming hard tonight at Jan Pešek. The Kingsville Kings need to protect that house, keep people and pucks away from Jan Pešek.
Well, the Kingsville Kings have a hashtag. It's called Protect the House, and that's something they use on their Twitter feeds, on their Facebook feeds, and it's really, really important. You can see some of the signs around here of people saying that. Protect the castle, and that's the key. So we've got a good contingency of Tottenham Steam fans here, and you can hear them cheering, and there's the horn from Tottenham. You can hear that as the teams make it to the ice. We're going to be set to go here in just a couple minutes. We're really glad that everybody's joined us last night and again tonight. We want to say a special hello to all the viewers in Tottenham. Glad that you could log on to we-tv.ca and enjoy your team, the Tottenham Steam, on WeTV. We're going to be back in just a little bit for the opening faceoff. Thanks for being here. And we'll see you in a bit.
It's new. It's fresh. It's innovative. It's WeTV, Windsor Essex Television, and you can watch it anywhere. www.we-tv.ca is the place to be. If it's sports, entertainment, or community events, WeTV has what you're looking for. The people, places, and faces of our community are front and center on WeTV. Check out www.we-tv.ca for what's being webcast live. WeTV, we got you covered.
Tom is trying to justify buying a new car. That should do it.
Need a good reason? There's never been a better time to get yourself into the best-selling car in Canada for 17 years. Now during the Honda Model Clearout, get a $1,000 Civic bonus when you finance any new 2015 Civic model.
We'll be right back.
Welcome back to Kingsville Arena. Mark Knight along with Steve Pronger. More Kingsville Kings hockey on this Friday night in Kingsville, Ontario, the southernmost community, southernmost municipality, I think is the correct word, in all of Canada. The visiting Tottenham Steam are here, ready to embark on Game 5 of a best-of-seven series. Let's have a look at our starting goaltender. Starting in goal again tonight, Denny Doublestein, wearing number 29, 17 games played, a 2.36 goals against average and a .922 save percentage with two shutouts, 12 wins, four losses so far in the playoffs. And starting for the Kingsville Kings, once again, they're going to go with Jan Pešek. Jan Pešek wears number 30, and in 15 games, he's got a 2.13 goals against average and a .943 save percentage with one shutout. And here we go. The Tottenham Steam win the opening faceoff, but the Kingsville Kings have got control. They're starting off with their third line tonight, and the puck comes off the corner boards, and Denny Doublestein grabs that puck and corrals that for the first faceoff, other than the opening.
Quick start here tonight, Mark, and there we look at our refereeing crew. They're already breaking up a scrum behind the Tottenham net. There they are, our referees tonight, J.P. St. Jules, Dave Fedek, as we see right there, St. Jules, and dropping the pucks and patrolling the lines is linesman Gord Young. The three referee last night, they did a great job as far as I'm concerned.
Same crew, just a couple of them wearing different armbands tonight. Fosterik goes down, tries to grab it, but Picard comes up with it in his own quick shot on Jan Pešek. And he comes up top of the blue ice with a big save.
Yeah, Mark, and Pešek gets into the game early, and I know he likes that. We've seen two stoppages of play here already within the first minute. He's into the game, and there's the captain of the Tottenham Steam, Kevin Walker. Great game from him last night. He is our WE TV player to watch. We'll focus on him a bit more later, the next stoppage of play.
Yeah, Walker had a lot of ice time last night. He's on the ice a lot. So, and then you can see him up there again right now as Freeman chops it down into the Kingsville zone. Jan Pešek comes out of the net to steer it to the corner. Austin Fisher back on. Looking to keep that in tight. It hops over his stick and goes all the way down.
Totting.
And Walker back in his own zone. He's checked off the puck, but he comes up with it again. Out to Lucas Havelka, number 4 for the Kingsville Kings. He shoves it over to Daniel Berdov, but it manages to get out. Stopped at the blue line, knocked back in. As Devin Dara circles, tries to pick up the puck and is unable to. A little bit of a bouncing puck there. No one can seem to get their stick on it as the Kingsville Kings are working. There's Timofeyev. Working hard in the zone, number 22 for the Tottenham Steam. He's down low, shovels it out front. Can't quite get a stick on it. And the Kingsville Kings dump it all the way down. Stike comes out of the bench, doesn't touch the puck, and icing is the call against the Kingsville Kings.
Mark, I think you're seeing a game tonight where you have two teams that are a bit timid. Both of them want to be disciplined here tonight. they don't want to end up in a situation like we saw the other night. Both of them a little timid, not willing to take some chances early.
I want to apologize to the viewers right now because Dmitry Belayev is wearing number 5, and that jersey belongs to James Hahn, and it says Hahn on the back. So I may call him Hahn once or twice tonight as he's on the ice, but it's actually Dmitry Belayev for all you Tottenham Steam fans. Kingsville Kings working in the Steam zone. Belayev with the puck. Knocks it back to the blue line, but not out. He's back in tight. He's checked by Niederbach. Niederbach is being shoved around by Stike. Stike pushes him into the corner. Hofford now on the blue line. Just about hopped out. Managed to keep it in. And here comes the Tottenham Steam. Little backhand landed on top of the net in behind Jan Pešek. I'm sure he thought it was going to go a little deeper than that. That could have been dangerous for the Kingsville Kings and fortuitous for the Tottenham Steam. As they break back out of their zone again, here comes Dylan Wallace. All the way down. Kind of makes contact with Jan Pešek's stick, and he's down. He's hurt. No referee arm up, and they need to blow the whistle on here. There's Niederbach with a break. Hojlov with the chop. Walker shovels it up. Freeman with the big shot. Correction, that's Johnson with the big shot. A little bit of pushing to keep things going. That was a really unfortunate situation as he went in and got caught there on Jan Pešek's stick. I don't think Pešek intended to trip him, but he did. And the Tottenham player went hard into the end boards. That had to hurt.
Yeah, we hope he's okay. Tottenham can't afford to lose anybody at this point in this playoff series. Certainly a player like Wallace, Mark.
Only got the one player out from last game, and that is Michael Bergman, number 26, who was on the roster last night, not playing tonight. Ivan Hojolov up across the blue line, coughs up the puck, and Surrey knocks it out. Brem knocks it back into the Kingsville zone. Steven Zegasy, a local boy, back in his own zone, shovels one high. Blake Nada is going after it, as is Dan Leach. Leach doesn't get to it in time. Brem knocks it out. And Zegasy quickly back into the Tottenham zone. Daniluk now off the glass. Out to center ice. Quick shot on Doublestein by Dan Leach. He handles that cleanly, but the Kings are offside.
Yeah, Mark, you see two teams out here so far that really don't appear too interested in playing hockey with the puck. And what I mean by that, it's always easier to play hockey without the puck. Why? Because you're basically on defense. In that case, you can apply pressure to the teams, some satisfied fans there, and both teams want to force the other team into mistakes.
Tottenham keeps the puck in the zone. There's Timofeyev. Knocks into the corner. Fisher now. Matt Fisher quickly over across. And Jan Pešek with the big save.
And, Mark, there you see Kevin Walker, the captain of the Tottenham Steam. What a great player for them. So far in the playoffs with 11 points, 19 game play, 2 goals, 9 assists from Timmins, Ontario. He had a ton of ice time last night. He's our WE TV player to watch from the Tottenham Steam.
Great numbers in 19 games for a defenseman, so keep an eye on him, Kevin Walker, tonight. Kingsville Kings shovel it out to the neutral zone. Austin Fisher passes it up to Matt Fisher. A little upset there by Marcel Kotek, and he comes up with the puck. Devin Dara can't quite control it. It gets shoveled back into the Tottenham zone, and there's Walker one more time behind his own net. Around to Timofeyev on the near boards. Shoveled over to the open wing. And Brendan York knocks it back behind his net. Here's York once again. He's got the puck. Dumps it in. Two steam go after it in the corner. Managed to get it out. Kevin Walker with a little backhand shovels it in. Jan Pešek with the easy save. Here's Timofeyev. Can't get a stick on it. Quick shot. Hits Jan Pešek up high. And the Kingsville Kings work the puck back out of their zone. Big stretch pass there, cut off by Jake Sterrett. But the Kingsville Kings come in. There's Gardeman. Quick pass across. Doublestein comes over and knocks the net off. Gorgeous opportunity for Ludwig Niederbach as he comes over and gives the fist bump to Gardeman. Great play by the Kingsville Kings, but Denny Doublestein was just a little better than that play.
You know, we've seen the Kingsville Kings. If you look at Doublestein there, Mark, a big save on that play, kicking the goal off. We did that last night. The Kings can, like a snake in the grass, they can just lay back, crawl around, and then all of a sudden jump on you with that chance on net. We saw that from Niederbach.
Niederbach's got some speed for a big man, and he uses it often here in this building. We've seen that time and time again. As Matthias Gardeman is in, taking a faceoff against Dylan Wallace. Kingsville Kings win the faceoff. Niederbach has a puck, throws two checks back to Hofford. Little soft pass goes off of Doublestein. Doublestein is laying. Gets the pop on the Kingsville player laying in his crease. And the other way come to Tottenham Steam. There's Johnson. He's checked by Gardeman, who gets back. Timofeyev up and over the net. Matt Fisher one more time. As the Kingsville Kings come up with a puck. Zach McDonough undercuts that check. Undercuts that check and gets the puck deep and goes for the change. A little whack at it by Hojolov. Not very good. Barely got it over the blue line, and the Tottenham Steam come down and get another shot from the blue line on Jan Pešek. They're taking their opportunities every chance they get now, as you say, Steve. You know, shots on net, and they're doing that.
They didn't have as many of them they should have last night, Mark, and that's true. You got to put pucks on net, but really, these perimeter shots are really not going to affect Pešek.
No, not at all, but you might change their mindset.
Remember last night we talked about puck luck.
Puck luck, yes. Quick shot in there by Surrey. And they're just dumping everything at the net. So Ryan Wood has definitely got his team geared up for tonight, a different game plan, and hopefully they can continue for the next 47 minutes or so. Brem one more time knocks it into the Kingsville zone. Walker's back on the ice for the Tottenham Steam. Steven Zegesi behind his own net. Shoots it up high. Up to Marvin Simmons. He gets chopped. Can't control the puck. There's Picard up and over the net. Another one over the net there from the blue line. Again, another quick shot there from the top of the faceoff circle. And Jan Pešek is getting work. He's well warmed up so far.
That's for sure. It looks like, Mark, he's going to be a lot busier tonight than he was last night. Again, Matt Fisher with the only goal last night was a beautiful shot beat him high. But it looks like that's the case as we look at these fans enjoying the game. Tottenham is going to throw everything at Pešek tonight.
Austin Fisher now on the blue line, keeping it in. Can't quite control it. Johnny Guerrero now. He's got two, and he gets chopped in the back. And no call there. Obvious cross-check to the back of Johnny Guerrero by Austin Fisher. And no call. Come up with a puck. Here's Matt Fisher now. Across over to Brandon York. York dumps one towards the net. It goes wide and behind. And Guerrero once again with a puck. Pushed off by Matt Fisher. Up to Matt Maddy. He's got Blake Nada with him. Soft pass over there. Blake Nada can't quite control it with the backhand. It just goes wide. Kevin Walker up to Matt Fisher. Fisher winds, but he's offside.
Kingsville Kings, Mark, have had a couple great chances so far. They are starting to apply that pressure. We look at the goal scorer last night, Fisher from Tottenham, and we all know that guy.
Grapes is in the house tonight. All right.
I was told if you weren't going to be here, I might have to work with that sign.
Well, might do a better job.
But as I was saying, Mark, we have another little break in play as linesman Gord Young has words with those two players right there. The Kingsville Kings are starting to turn up the volume a little bit.
Dylan Wallace and Zach Zolkanics are making their positions known, and Gord Young had to have a little chat with them. And here comes Ludwig Niederbach in his zone, up the left side. He gets chopped off by Linklater. Colin Hoffer now circles back in neutral zone. Little soft pass up and deep in the zone. Doubles time behind his net. Zolkanics goes after him. A little bit of a miscue there. And Wallace comes up with it. A little more pushing and shoving there. And looks like we've got a penalty call.
Mark, I couldn't see from my vantage point, but we see referee St. Jules talking to Gord Young, our linesman there. Now Fedek is joining in the other armband.
And I have to apologize. I don't know if in this league, in the GMHL, if you're allowed to continue play without a helmet. So we're going to see what the call is and see if it's Stike's going to go to the box. Because he did continue to play without his helmet. And in most leagues, that is an infraction. You can see Dave Fedek having a chat with Ryan Wood. The penalty box door is open, and the procession is about to begin. So Ryan Wood is shaking his hands, not really sure what's going on, but they're waiting for the player to get over there.
Yeah, Ryan Wood found his way out of the game last night. I hope he would be careful. We chalked it up to lessons learned, Mark. He's there gesturing at the referee, Dave Fedek, issuing one of his players over. It looks like some confusion.
Call. It is Stike. So Stike continued to play without his helmet, and he's being called for, you know, an equipment violation. So that's the right call. You have to either pick up your helmet and put it back on or head to the bench. Do not engage back in play. Kingsville Kings on the power play, 11:45 to go here in the first period. A little bit of a scuttle there after the faceoff. Puck gets over to Kotek. Kotek shoots through a crowd. That's blocked by Brem right in front. Hojlov now, he's looking. Over to Hovelkar, player to watch on the Kingsville Kings. Dumps it towards the net, again, off of a body. One shooter and seven players in front of the net. There's not much room for that puck to get through. But if placed just right, it finds the back of the net. Ivan Hojlov quickly over to Kotek. Kotek backpedals. Looks, no lane. Chopped off. Quick shot in the net. Kotek through the pile of people, and he puts one in the net. Power play goal, Kingsville Kings. They get it started.
Mark, there it is. Kingsville, as you know, could not score on the power play last night. The fans here are obviously satisfied, finally seeing a power play goal from the Kingsville Kings early in this hockey game. What a message this is sending to the Tottenham Steam right away. There he is, Marcel Kotek, a tremendous shot from the point. That power play strategy works when you have people in front of the net. Goaltender Doublestein can't see anything. A nice low shot, 6 inches off the ice by Kotek, finds the back of the net.
Patience. The patience that he possessed in that play were great. So now we got a penalty here for the Kingsville Kings. Marvin Simmons is going over. I didn't see the motion, likely an unsportsmanlike conduct call, but we'll get that in a little bit.
Mark, that looks like it might take back that goal.
And it did.
Yep.
It did.
We have 4-on-4 hockey now, Mark. It looks like whatever Simmons did or that or it happened, it Coach Estolas there gesturing to the referee, wanting to know what's going on, what's happened. C.J. Nicholson now making his way.
Yeah, well, we got the hopefully they've got the right person in the box. Nicholson in the box. Marvin Simmons back on the bench. 4-on-4 hockey, no goal.
And a great shot by Kotek. Oh, wasted.
Wasted. There'll be more opportunities. So Nicholson gets a goaltender interference penalty, thus the negating the goal. Austin Fisher behind his own net having all kinds of trouble with Ludwig Niederbach. A lot of stick work there. One got up around Kevin Walker's neck. I think it was more of a hand than a stick, and play goes on. Tottenham Steam. Timofeyev up to Matt Fisher. Can't quite control it. Zegosi chops it off, and Vosterik dumps it out. Devin Dara goes after it. Timofeyev cuts him off. Kevin Walker gets a look up to Matt Fisher. Fisher over the blue line. Back to Walker. A little soft shot, but well wide of the net. Austin Fisher, big shot on Jan Pešek through a crowd. He makes the save. Timofeyev fighting in his most familiar corner of last night. He was in that corner a lot, digging for the puck. That was close to carrying the puck as the Kingsville bench is calling for a penalty there. Timofeyev drops it back to Matt Fisher. Matt Fisher over to Austin Fisher. Quick shot on Jan Pešek. They're getting the shots. They're listening to Steve's keys as the Tottenham Steam are now full strength. They have a 35-second power play here as Pickard comes on the ice. Replacing Steich out of the penalty box. Quick shot high of the net, and it goes all the way down into the Tottenham zone. Walker quickly up to Matt Fisher. Fisher, little spin, dumping it back into Pickard. Pickard behind the Kingsville net. He's looking. Still has a puck. Shovels it off, but Marvin Simmons gets his stick on it and knocks it out of the zone. 8 seconds to go in C.J. Nicholson's penalty. Last chance here for the Tottenham Steam on this power play as Callum Hofford is able to thwart Matt Fisher and keep it out of the zone. Penalty box is empty. Back to 5-on-5 hockey, and the Tottenham Steam are still in the Kingsville zone. As the puck squirts out, here comes C.J. Nicholson out of the box. Lots of speed, lots of steam, and just shoots it wide. Zach McDonough grabs it at center ice, dumps it back in the zone. The Kingsville Kings go for a change. Johnny Guerrero now chasing it around. Dmitry Daniluk shovels it around off the boards. Vosterik has to hurry up to get it. Vosterik he's caught. Tottenham Steam, Pickard. Over to York. York spins, loses an edge. Can't quite control the puck. Robert Liss is on it. There's York now. Quick shot.
Great block there by Zach McDonough.
Oh. And he comes away with the puck. And Johnny just misses a check by Johnny Guerrero, and the Kingsville Kings are all of a sudden down in the zone. Matt Maddy is pushing and shoving there with Jake Sterrett. Back out to neutral ice. Johnny Guerrero tries to kick it up. Daniluk throws it high and away from the crowd. Guerrero one more time. Jake Sterrett dumps it back to neutral ice, and we got an offside call as Matt Maddy brings it in. Johnny Guerrero didn't have a chance to check up.
Mark, they finally get an opportunity to look at our WeTV player of the game for the Kingsville Kings, Lukas Havelka from Prague, Czechoslovakia. Great standout with 17 points in this playoff.
Well, we're looking at a pair of fours tonight. Number four for the Tottenham Steam, Kevin Walker. Number four, Lukas Havelka for the Kingsville Kings, the WeTV players to watch. Jake Starrett behind his own net. He shoves it over, gets it up to Wallace, but C.J. Nicholson is there. Correction. Yeah, C.J. Nicholson is in there to pick up that puck. Starrett one more time. Gets it out. Marcel Kotek throws it a little too high, and it goes off one of the girders, and we have a stoppage in play.
Yeah, back to Havelka, WeTV player to watch from the Kingsville Kings. He's been a standout on defense. 7 goals, 10 assists, 17 points in 18 playoff games. And really, you look at the crowd here at Kingsville, they love this guy. They are so happy with these European imports that the Kingsville Kings has.
And the Kingsville team has quite a few of them. We were counting them up there just before the game. We were quite surprised at the number of players from places other than Canada. A little pushing and shoving there in front of the Tottenham bench. Efimov and Zolkanics having words as they make their way back to the faceoff dot. Kingsville Kings going with their top line.
Yeah, there's Doublestein. We thought we beat him, the Kingsville Kings rather, on a great shot from Kotek. Beat him on that power play. It was not to be, Mark. Tie score with 7 minutes left.
And that would have been an assist to Lucas Havelka on that non-goal. Digging for it in the corner, they get it out. Here comes Ludwig Niederbach. Tries to shovel it over to Zolkanics. And we get a little bit of a dump up. A little pushing and shoving. Walker and Zolkanics. Didn't like the way that Zolkanics backed his way into the net. Nonetheless, the net was sent for a sprint. And we'll get that straightened out in just a second. Doublestein is making sure he gets his words in there.
Dave Fedek was one of the linesmen last night. He's in the middle there sorting it out. He had to do a lot of that last night. Kevin Walker from Timmins, Ontario, Northern Ontario boy, he's not a stranger to this type of hockey. He's played a lot of that style. And also we know Zach Zolkanic from Kenai River, Alaska. He's he's not shy either, Mark.
And that was just a really good hockey play. And Walker played it perfectly, Zolkanics played it perfectly, and Doublestein just had to get out of the way. Faceoff won by the Kingsville Kings, quick shot on net, but it goes wide. David Vosterik hits the brakes, catches the puck, and up and over Denny Doublestein it goes. Dan Leach on the far boards, shovels it up to Hojlov. He's pushed off the puck. Now Frederick Surrey gets it out of the Kingsville, out of the Tottenham zone. Picard has a look. He's got something wrong with his skate. He's going to go for a change. Ovchinnikov comes in and replaces him. Little touch pass there on the blue line as Frederick Surrey comes across, tries to double it back, but Marvin Simmons is right there. Dan Leach with Simmons across the blue line. They got Hojlov with him now. Hojlov cycles in front of the slot. Quick shot there, wide of the net, but Denny Doublestein says, no, we're going to hold this one right here, get a faceoff with 5:50. Nine to go.
Doublestein reaching out to grab that puck. Easy save for him to make. It was outside of what you might consider the prime scoring area. But even the third line of the Kingsville Kings, Simmons there applying pressure. Kingsville keeps coming and coming, Mark.
Johnny Guerrero wins that faceoff, dumps it back, and Sweeney picks it up quickly and shovels it into the Kingsville zone. Zach McDonough. He's being pushed off the puck by Sweeney. He manages to squirt out the small frame. Can get places that most people can't, and the puck goes into the Tottenham bench.
Things seem a little more calm on the Tottenham bench. I know we're only into the first period here, Mark, than it was last night. You and I right below us got to witness quite an affair from the Tottenham bench. It seems a bit calmer. It's nice to see this league-leading team playing hockey tonight, focusing on winning this game tonight. They want to go home with a win.
Well, last night's game was a one goal for the Kingsville Kings and a penalty apiece in the first period. Everything the wheels fell off the cart in the second period, so we've got the time for that to happen yet tonight. Back to Starrett. He shovels it back in. Zach McDonough dumps it back to neutral ice. And we got a high-sticking the puck call. So the faceoff will be back in the Tottenham zone.
Yeah, we look into the eyes of Jan Pešek there. Prague, Czechoslovakia, he wants to take a championship home to Europe for sure. That's why he's come here, Mark. All these European imports want to play in Canada. They want to win in Canada.
This is where the hockey is being played, and they're doing a great job of it here tonight, the Tottenham's team and the Kingsville Kings at the Kingsville Arena Complex Game 5 on the Russell Cup Finals. Tottenham up across the zone, and Sweeney takes a big check by C.J. Nicholson. He got upset there, and his stick went flying, and he had the wind knocked out of him there. Big check there, open ice check, and comes down the other way and a shot on Doublestein.
Well, Sweeney seems to be okay enough. He's yelling back at the bench at somebody, whether it's the Kingsville Kings player that hit him or it was the referee who made the non-call, perhaps J.P. St. Jules standing here at center ice. But regardless, Mark, that was a solid open ice neutral zone check. You got to keep your head up coming through the middle of the ice.
Well, and the music is perfect. We will rock you. They're playing here in the arena. And that's what just happened there. C.J. Nicholson on Sweeney. Big check, big shot wide of the net. Doublestein wasn't sure where that was. He didn't move. But the puck missed the net. Step on Timofeyev and Matt Fisher now. Can't quite get it over the blue line. Another big check there as Austin Fisher throws his weight around on Ludwig Niederbach. We're going to see more of that tonight as Zolkanics and Niederbach come across the zone. Niederbach there and Fisher. Niederbach stands up. A little bit of a pinball into Kevin Walker. As Fisher knocks him around. Here's Zegesi on his horse. Make sure he gets it out. Marcel Kotek has to duck. And there's another. That's getting close to aggression there. As Austin Fisher is going after Ludwig Niederbach. We've seen that. He's been kicked out of both games he's played in this building thus far. And we're just 4 minutes to go in the first period. Another shot on Jan Pešek. And York is right there. Makes the swipe.
Yeah, you look at Austin Fisher. Well, we're not seeing him. That's the other Fisher, the goal scorer from last night. Leading scorer for the Tottenham team in regular season. Matt Fisher, standout player. But number 20, the other Fisher, Austin, was ejected from the game last night for, I believe, took a major penalty on Ludwig Niederbach. The two of them seem to have developed a history. Fisher wanting to get the best of Ludwig Niederbach in this building, Mark.
Yeah, the first game he landed a punch on Ludwig Niederbach and was invited to leave. Last night he got charged with a five-minute butt ending and a game misconduct. Little soft backhand there onto Danny Doublestein and more pushing and shoving after the whistle.
Yeah, Dave Fedek in the middle of it. He's going to keep things cool for sure. I spoke to him before the game, and they didn't know what to expect as an officiating group here tonight. They didn't know if they're going to get a quiet game based on last night or another game like last night based
night. It's a hard game, another one up into the roofing, and we're going to have another face-off there to the left of Danny Doublestein. But getting back to that, you can just see the players, even in Game 5, they're still positioning themselves. They're letting them know you're not going to push me around, and it's coming from both sides of the rink. Quick shot there, Danny Doublestein handles that easily and steers it to the corner. As Freeman shovels it across. Tottenham team have to tag up off the end boards and up to Jan Pešek. Knocks that down. There's Picard working down low. He gets it around to Brehm. Brehm skates it into the corner. Picard being knocked around there a little bit. Puck comes back. It comes out. It. And just through the blue ice and icing for the Kingsville Kings.
Mark, there's nothing wrong icing the puck at this point of a period, a first period certainly in this game. Doublestein's having a rest, no doubt his counterpart at the other end. Jan Pešek is having a rest. There, look at that, Mark. There's Rory.
Rory's here tonight. Good.
Rory is here at the Kingsville Arena, and there was a great shot of him. I know he's going around sharing the love of the Kingsville Kings hockey with the fans here tonight. It is a great night for a hockey game.
Well, Dan Leach just upset Johnson, and he was asked to leave the faceoff dot. Johnson got knocked down to his knees, but the Kingsville Kings win that faceoff and knock it out of the zone. Here's Steich. Quickly up to Linklater. Across the blue line. Over. Can't quite control it. Dylan Wallace knocks it into the corner. Jan Pešek now stretching around behind his net. Looks like the referee lost sight of the puck and a quick whistle there.
You know, Zach McDonough, not very tall in stature. We see his mouth going there. He's going to protect his goalie. And I said one of the keys for the Kingsville Kings tonight, Zach McDonough must have heard me, is protect that house. You know, they don't want any white shirt standing right next to Jan Pešek.
Well, I'm glad I wore blue tonight, Steve. I see you've got your WeTV blue on as well.
Yes, I'm representing for sure.
Colm Hofford up out of the zone, up to Hojolov. Can't quite control it. And there's McDonough. He's got a lane. He's going to take it. Kevin Walker tried to chop him off the puck, and there's McDonough pushing Austin Fisher around. Not much success in that. He probably gives up about 80 pounds. but he tries. Dylan Wallace dumps it into the corner. Colm Hoffer goes after it. He hears the sound of the skates and checks up and looks to see where the hit's coming from. Matt Fisher on Holland. Quick shot back in there by Austin Fisher. And Hojlov kicks it out. The Steam seem to have a little different game plan here tonight. They're working the puck and working the play and not too much extraneous. They're settled it down a bit, and it's good to see.
Yeah, well, as I said at the beginning of the game, they have to play smart before they play hard. Anybody can play hard. You get frustrated, excited, you play hard, it comes naturally. What they have to do is settle down and play smart.
Ovchinnikov. And Danilek in the corner. Shovels it around to Brehm. Timofeyev, nice little soft pass up to Matt Fisher. Fisher, the goal scorer the other night, tries one move too many. And Lucas Pavelka takes the puck from him. Little backhand in. The bench wants an icing call, and that is not going to be had. Blake Nada, Matt Matty in there. And the Steam knock it out. Icing is waved off. Marcel Kotek comes back in the zone to pick up the puck. York checking him. Gets the whack. Kotek comes in, still has the puck. Brehm upends him. Puck hit something on the ice and bounced a little bit, but the Kingsville Kings come out. Freeman dumps it back into the Kingsville zone. Kotek once again back out to neutral ice. Nothing's setting up. It's just get the puck out of the zone and move it along. So be on the lookout there. There's a big attempted check by Danilek, and he missed. Blake Nada throws a check there on Jake Sterrett, and they're having words. Back the other way. Tottenham Steam come in. Upend Steven Zegesi, and here's Niederbach in alone with Jake Sterrett. Knocked off the puck. Zolkanek tries to pick up there, and Niederbach gets a chop. No call, referee right there. As the whistle winds and lets us know the period has ending, Ludwig Niederbach gets whacked behind the play. He's looking for something extra. You can bet that the second period may very well present itself just a little bit differently here in the Kingsville Arena Complex.
Well, if Ludwig Niederbach wants something extra there, he's not going to get it from one of these three referees, Mark. After last night's game, I think the referees are going to try their best to really keep it as tight as they can. They don't want to be giving anything away and be accused of, you know, being a homer for sure. I'm not saying they are. I don't think they are. They've called a good first period. What I see is two teams. You're right. They must have heard me somewhat because the Tottenham Steam are playing smarter before they're playing hard, and the Kingsville Kings are really, really putting up a wall in front of Jan Prashik. They're protecting that house.
Well, I don't know if you know this, Steve, but Steve's keys are infamous, so I know they listen. There you have the score. Tottenham Steam, Kingsville Kings, no score, although one went in the net. It was called back because of a goaltender interference penalty, but that's where we sit at the end of the first period. Series tied at 2, game tied at 0. We'll be back for the second period in just a bit. Stay with us.
It's new, it's fresh, it's innovative, it's WeTV, Windsor Essex Television, and you can watch it anywhere. www.we-tv.ca is the place to be. If it's sports, entertainment, or community events, WeTV has what you're looking for. The people, places, and faces of our community are front and center on WeTV. Check out www.we-tv.ca for what's being webcast live. WeTV, we got you covered.
Tom is trying to justify buying a new car. That should do it.
Need a good reason? There's never been a better time to get yourself into the best-selling car in Canada for 17 years. Now during the Honda Model Clearout, get a $1,000 Civic bonus when you finance any new 2015 Civic model. ¶¶
local, WE TV.
Hi, I'm Joel Quenneville, coach of the Chicago Blackhawks, and a proud graduate of FJ Brennan High. I can remember fondly my 5 great years at Brennan. It seems like just yesterday that we were there. A lot of great life lessons that I learned along the way, particularly from my teachers in the Catholic program. Want to wish everybody there good luck, and look forward to being a proud graduate and being a proud Cardinal going on here in Chicago.
Manpower. That's our specialty. We use it to build infrastructure, like the $1 billion parkway. That's real manpower in action. End to end, over 1,000 strong, forming bridges, carving out tunnels, shaping roadways. Our manpower is in demand. Well trained, highly skilled, tough as nails. We've got what it takes to build your career. A solid career for building a better future. LIUNA. Feel the power.
Windsor Essex Sports Connection, WE TV. It's new. It's fresh. It's innovative. It's WeTV, Windsor Essex Television, and you can watch it anywhere. www.we-tv.ca is the place to be. If it's sports, entertainment, or community events, WeTV has what you're looking for. The people, the places, and faces of our community are front and center on WeTV. Check out www.we-tv.ca for what's being webcast live. WeTV, we got you covered.
Tom is trying to justify buying a new car. That should do it.
Need a good reason? There's never been a better time to get yourself into the best-selling car in Canada for 17 years. Now during the Honda Model Clearout, get a $1,000 Civic bonus when you finance any new 2015 Civic model.
Hi, I'm Joel Quenneville, coach of the Chicago Blackhawks, and a proud graduate of FJ Brennan High. I can remember fondly my five great years at Brennan. It seems like just yesterday that we were there. A lot of great life lessons that I learned along the way, particularly from my teachers and the Catholic program. I want to wish everybody there good luck, and look forward to being a proud graduate and being a proud Cardinal going on here in, here in Chicago.
Welcome back to the Kings Hill Arena. Mark Knight along with Steve Pronger. Steve, after 13 periods of play, nothing has been decided. The series is tied at two. No score in the first period of Game 5 in the Russell Cup Final.
No, kind of a quiet period. Both teams feeling each other out and really...
Literally.
No one wants to make a mistake. No one wants to make a mistake as we watch the ice dry here. Typical of a Game 5 first period. Game 5 means everything. Everything counts after this game. If you win this game, percentage-wise, statistically, you're going to win this series.
Well, there you see it. The next game is Sunday, April 3rd in Tottenham at 5:30 start. That will not be on WeTV, and we'll be cheering on the Kingsville Kings and the Tottenham team to see what happens. That's Game 6 of the Russell Cup Final. And then if there is a Game 7, that's back here Monday, April the 4th. Time to be announced here in Kingsville Arena. The Tottenham team will make the trip one last time to decide who will hoist the Russell Cup.
But you know what, Mark? WeTV, since we're talking about it, has something for everybody, don't they?
Absolutely. We're not just hockey. We're not just baseball. We've got the Windsor Adult Volleyball League Championship Day coming up Wednesday, April the 6th, and that's live on WeTV. 6:30 p.m. start from the St. Clair College Sportsplex. If you haven't been to St. Clair College in the last couple of years, you need to spend some time heading over there. That's a beautiful place. Going to be a great broadcast, and that's coming in April on WeTV. Well, we're in April now, so it's April the 1st, April Fool's Day, but that's coming up on April the 6th. And just have a look at what's happened thus far in the Russell Cup Final. Game 1, in overtime, the Tottenham team beat the Kingsville Kings 6-5, then the 3-1 at Tottenham. And Kingsville, in Kingsville, were 3-2 at Tottenham, and then Kingsville 6-1 in the last game. That crazy second period of a game, and we're tied no score here just into the second period. As the Tottenham team shoveled out to neutral ice, get it all the way down to the blue line. Zach Zolkanek's fighting for the puck. He shovels it in. Denny Doublestein behind his net. Steven Zegesi gets the shot towards the net. That goes off a stick and way into the corner as the steam come out. Here's Surrey. Puck's knocked off his stick. Pushing and shoving here, and Steven Zegesi puts it right back on Surrey's stick. Quick shot on Jan Pešek there by Thomas Freeman. Puck into the corner. Freeman's working. Surrey trying to push Havelka off the puck, and he shovels it down. Austin Fisher gives it up to Nicholson. Not the guy he wanted to give the puck to, but got a penalty coming up here to the Tottenham Steam for a cross check. And
yeah,
looks like Austin Fisher, after he shoveled the puck and he gave it to Nicholson, he gave him a little bit more than just the puck with the cross check. The wood across the back, and he's going to sit two or less in the second period.
Yeah, good hustle there by C.J. Nicholson, coming out with speed and aggression, forcing Austin Fisher to not move his feet and use his stick. We saw that a lot from them last night, Mark. They got in penalty trouble when they started to use the sticks.
And he's the man that started the parade to the penalty box last night, so we'll see if that is a little bit of deja vu. Tottenham Steam shovel the puck all the way down to the Kingsville zone. Colin Hofford back there with it. He gets away from Dylan Wallace. Gets the puck up to Zach Zolkanix. He splits the D. Gets a shot across to Ludwig Niederbach. Niederbach buries that one quickly. 21 seconds into that power play. Great play. Hofford to Zolkanix and over to Niederbach. And he makes no mistake. Standing on the doorstep. And Doublestein had no chance.
Mark, the Kingsville crowd is obviously happy about this. They had a goal denied in the first period on a great shot by Kotick. But there they are, the 1-2 punch, Zolkanix and Niederbach. They've played together well since midseason. Certainly the two of them are 1-2 in the scoring for playoffs for the Kingsville Kings. They've just connected, giving Kingsville a 1-0 lead on this power play early in the second period.
Great pass by Zach Zolkanix. And here's Matt Fisher coming the other way, the goal scorer the other night for the Tottenham Steam, and he gets a second whack at it. A little bit of pushing and shoving there in front of the net. Step on Timofeyev is asking a question.
Good effort by Matt Fisher there. Like to see players take shots and really go hard to the net to try to get their own rebound. Often the goaltender's waiting for a defenseman to shove it away. They don't expect the forward to get a second whack at it.
Well, the 146 points in the regular season, I'm sure that's a play he makes often. Kotek over to Havelka. Quick feed up to Devin Derry. He taps it, but can't quite control it. Well, they give the second assist to Steven Zegese, so that's Niederbach from Zolkanix and Zegese on the first goal of this game here, game five of the Russell Cup. Stepan Timofeyev. A little give and go, gets it back off the stick, back into the corner. He comes up, tries to shovel one on the far side and misses the net. Little direction and redeflection. Looks like Timofeyev might have got a stick on that as it went through the crowd and it beat Jan Pešek. So just that quickly, in less than a minute, we have a tie game, 1-1. Nothing has been decided.
We have a great group of fans here from Tottenham for sure. They're right in front of us. They're very happy at that goal. You can see them. We can see them screaming, yelling. There's Jan Pešek there. And really, if you stick to the thought that Ryan Wood gave me before the game, they need to put everything at the net, fill the house with pucks, and really it looks like that paid off.
Absolutely it did. Shovel that, and we'll have to wait for the call to see who got their stick on it, but I think that was Stepan Timofeyev with the goal. Kingsville Kings, Marvin Simmons working in his own zone now. Dan Leach is circling around, trying to come up with it. There's Zegese. Shoveled it back to Jan Pešek. Out to the corner, but Balea was there to get the puck. There's Sterrett knocking it back into the zone. Balea on the far corner. Dan Leach. Oh, big check by Dan Leach. No arm up. I thought that might have been a little bit high. The referee didn't think so. Balea behind the Kingsville net. Up to Dylan Wallace. Wallace is pushed off the puck. And they shovel it out to neutral ice. Walker off the boards. And you can hear the chant, go Steam, go. Marvin Simmons tries to pull one down. And Hojlov is in the zone with Dan Leach. Dan Leach into the corner. Gets away from his check. Hits the brakes, clears away from that check one more time. Picard now comes away. 1-on-3. And the Kingsville Kings stop forward motion of the Tottenham Steam. Sterrett now catches it, drops it down, throws it back into the Kingsville zone. Bosterek with a stretch pass. touched up there by Hojolov to negate the icing. And it comes out front. Couldn't quite get it up to Johnny Guerrero. Johnny Guerrero now with the puck. Across the blue line. Bounces off the end boards. Gets into it, gets his own rebound. Robert List now working down low. Tries to get it back to Guerrero. He's knocked off the puck, and the steam throw it out of the zone. Clear to an open wing. Another big check there by Guerrero. Steven Zegesi behind his own net. Quickly up to Robert List. He can't quite handle the pass. Back in the Kingsville zone, Steven Zegesi coming out of his zone. On the four boards, he's chopped off it. Puck goes up and into the netting. We'll have a stoppage in play.
Mark, Kingsville took a 1-0 lead on Ludwig Niederbach's 15th of the playoffs. Power play goal with assist going. A great pass of Zach Zalkanik and Steven Zegesi at 1:32. And 1 minute later, roughly, Tottenham tied it up on Timofeyev, his 22nd goal of the playoffs, from Daniluk and York at 2:23.
Big shot there by York. We got an assist on the Tottenham goal. Back down Zalkanik, sidesteps the check. Over to Gardeman. Gardeman can't quite catch the bouncing puck. And back out of the zone. Here comes Timofeyev up across the blue line. He's checked, gets a puck over to York. York throws it up above the net. It comes back around front. Matt Fisher has it. Jan Pasek is without a stick. Fisher can't quite get the puck in. He gets it over and tipped in by Brandon York, who is parked in front. And Jan Pešek, without a stick, was unable to defend the house in the way that he'd like to. And the Tottenham Steam go up 2-1 on the Kingsville Kings.
Some happy Steam fans there for sure. York got an assist on their first goal. Now the recipient of that one. And you know what, Mark? Looking back at that play, I think Jan Pešek, without a stick, was distracted. He was focusing on York, focusing on the play. His defenseman brought him the stick, was attempting to bring him the stick over from the corner. I think Pešek was distracted from that, looked away just as the puck was coming at him.
Well, kudos to Matt Fisher for using that to his advantage, and he waited until Jan Pešek looked away and shoveled the puck right towards the net, and York knocked it in while Jan Pešek was looking at his defenseman. You called that exactly right, Steve. Stepan Timofeyev working on Colin Hofford. Zach McDonough back in his own zone. Up off the glass. Burdov now. Back to Hofford. Hofford in the corner. You hear the Steam fans chanting now. They've got something to chat about now. Quick shot there. And Doublestein reaches out to grab that with no black sweaters in the vicinity, but he wants to stop the play.
Yeah, Doublestein there now finds himself in a good position. He's one goal up. He can relax a bit. Jan Pešek, on the other hand, hasn't found himself many of these situations. And I really think while his defenseman was doing the right thing, get the goaltender the stick, I think timing was everything there, Mark. The stick coming to Pešek just as the shot was being made. Kingsville's down 2-1.
Quick shot on net by Simmons there. Back to Vosterik. Vosterik dumps it in, and Freeman gets knocked off the puck. There's Frederick Surrey. Shovels it back into the Kingsville zone. David Vosterik goes back to get it. Vosterik, he has a lane. Freeman's on him, forces him to shoot the puck in, and Denny Doublestein grabs that with Blake Nada on the doorstep.
Yeah, the Steam, Mark, they didn't end up 41-4 in the regular season for no reason. They can score goals. They can play hockey. They know how to win hockey games. And just evidence right there. Now Doublestein has a 2-1 lead. He's going to cover that puck and slow things down in his own end whenever he can. Smart hockey playing. And that's what I said. They, the Steam, have to play smart in this building.
Johnny Guerrero there against Fisher comes up with the faceoff, tries to shovel in front of Doublestein. It gets deflected in the back. Robert List throws a big check on Fisher. I think Fisher's down. Whistle is gone. They're calling for a trainer. I think he might have got rubbed out on the dasher board there. And it looks like there might be a little bit of blood on the ice. Yeah, you can see some blood in his face. Correction, that's not Fisher. That's Trent Lindlaker.
Yeah, it looked like you're going to the bench there. It looks like he might have hit his face on the dashboard. That's a common injury, Mark. It happens more than you think. That little lip coming out from the bottom of the glass. You bend over, you bend your knees, you get pushed or checked forward. It's head to dashboard, and you see some blood like we did with the Steam player.
Seven minutes gone here in the second period. The Tottenham Steam are up 2-1. Face-off won by Tottenham, and they get it out of the zone. Good to see that not many penalties are being called in the game. You can hear some of the fans thinking there should be more as Stepan Timofeyev gets the puck up to Wallace. Wallace gets around to Danlich, back behind the net to Wallace. Working behind the Kingsville net, and Wallace has a great shot, just misses wide as Timofeyev is right in front. Couldn't handle the pass. Steven Zegosy now. And the bodies are starting to fly in the same place that Linklater went down. We had a big check there on Blake Nada as Brehm throwing his weight. Danlich back to Johnson. Up and over, and Wallace knocks it into the zone, goes for a change. Frederick Surrey on to replace him. Mosterik quickly up to Niederbach. Niederbach can't quite control the puck. Puck squirts into the zone, back out. Niederbach has to tag up. Garderman now. Getting the chase on Steich. Mosterik back in his own zone, can't quite get there. But icing is the call on the Tottenham Steam.
Mark, at 5:36 of the second period, it was Brandon York. He assisted on the first Tottenham goal. Brandon York's 10th of the playoff from Timofeyev and Matt Fisher, giving Tottenham a 2-1 lead in this hockey game.
And that's where we sit right now, just over 7 minutes gone. Just over 8 minutes gone, sorry. Quick pass out through the slot. Nobody there to pick it up. And the Steam come away. Frederick Surrey across the blue line. Big shot. Used Havelka for a screen, but missed the net. There's Jan Pešek. Big shot. He's upended, and he drives his player right into the end boards. And now we got some pushing and shoving as Okanics is in there. Two people on him. And Ludwig Niederbach comes around to help his teammate.
Well, let's see, Mark. Referee St. Jules is there. We can see him making hand gestures. It looks like he's...
Taps Okanics. He's going for sure. And looks like, yeah, Zach Okanics and Steich are gone. So
it's going to even it out. Kingsville Kings are going to play 4-on-4. You know they love that. Two roughing penalties, I guess.
Likely. Zach and Zach are in the box.
You know, Zach Zolkanik's got to be careful. You know, the Kingsville Kings need him on the ice. And let's face it, if I'm Coach Ryan Wood, I'm going to try to draw people like Niederbach or Zolkanik's into the box and off the ice. So these boys got to be careful, got to keep their heads.
Devin Dare in to take the faceoff. He grabs it and goes forward, gets all the way to the end boards with it. Comes back to Havelka, our player to watch. A rising shot goes up and over the net. Timofeyev never minds the puck and tries to throw the check. There's Kevin Walker now on Devin Dara. Devin Dara, good puck position. Still has the puck. Comes out of the scrum, and he gets the shot off. Great shot by Devin Dara. And he goes back into the corner after his own rebound. Devin Dara, the workhorse of the Kingsville Kings, doing it all out there. As the Steam come out of their zone, and Devin Dara comes across the near boards and throws the big check. Now here's Havelka. Niederbach on to replace Devin Dara. Timofeyev. Over to Picard. Picard behind the net. He's looking. He's cycling. A little soft backhand, but Ludwig Niederbach's stick was in the way. CJ Nicholson tried the same play, and he wasn't able to get it through. Pass up. Icing is the indicator, but it's right on net, so that's negated as Ludwig Niederbach is looming large on top of the crease, but nothing to be had.
Yeah, Devin Dara from Saranac Lake, New York, an American import in the Kingsville Kings. What a shift from him, Mark, that last shift. He single-handedly took the puck. He beat Kevin Walker out of the corner. It looked like a couple times. Almost had a great opportunity in on Dubelstein to tie this hockey game. Great show, great effort by Devin Dara.
He reminded me a lot of an old Toronto Maple Leaf draft pick, Kenny Ryan, who used to play for the Windsor Spitfires. Great man in the corner. And Devin Dara exhibited that perfectly. Quick shot there, chopped down at the blue line, but it makes it all the way into Jan Pešek, and he doesn't handle it cleanly. I think he wanted to shovel it to the corner, but couldn't quite grab it up in his glove. We're going to have a face-off to the left of Jan Pešek.
Looks like it's getting more physical out there. There's Blake Nada going to take his spot at the dot, but he was a recipient of a big body check there.
Surrey tries to shovel it in. Hofford comes back, collects the puck, head up across the blue line. Nowhere to pass, decides to carry it in himself. Quickly over to Gardeman. Gardeman with the shot wide of the net. Here's Zach McDonough. Speedy Zach McDonough into the corner. He gets knocked down. Helmet off. No, sorry, that was a glove off. McDonough was slow to get up as he gets back to Hofford. And up under the netting, and play is called.
Mark, the State of the Union address halfway through this hockey game is both teams appear to be saying, hey, we're going to win this hockey game, but you got to come through me first, okay? And both teams are setting themselves up for what looks like to be a physical affair here. The body checking is increased. Now that Tottingham has a lead, they're going to protect that lead with physicality. And the Kingsville Kings don't seem to be shying away. They're going to give it right back in kind.
I remember the last time I said that if you're going to score a goal, you're going to have to come through me. And I got knocked to the ice and ended up with a cracked sternum that night. So sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. But it's working right now for the Kingsville Kings and the Tottenham Steam. As the Steam shovel it down the ice and can't quite catch the pass and goes all the way down into the Kingsville zone for another icing.
So if I'm the Kingsville Kings, what I'm looking at is to get that puck deep. Obviously, that's easy. You shoot it in. But the second part of this, you got to go after it, be physical, get it back, and take it to the net. Well, keep an eye on Kingsville to see how well they do that.
You saw Ryan Wood there giving his teammates instructions as to don't ice the puck when you have that situation. But back into the Tottenham zone. Zagasy fakes the shot, goes off a stick, and up into the netting. We're going to have another faceoff in the Tottenham zone.
And you mentioned Ryan Wood, and as a coach, he found himself out of the game last night, but he's in a completely different game tonight, Mark. He finds himself now leading 2-1 when he was down 4-1 or 5-1 at this point last night, himself being out of the game. He's got an opportunity here to coach and to really reestablish the Tottenham Steam as the premier team in this league.
Premier is absolutely right. They were the number one team in the regular season in the Central Division and of the whole league, losing only one game through the regular season, 41-1. Great record for the Tottenham Steam. And the Steam win that faceoff and get the puck out of the zone. Vosterik dumps it back in. Robert List goes in, throws a check, keeps the puck in. As Dan Leach comes in to help out. Marvin Simmons can't quite control it. And there's Brandon York, the goal scorer with another big shot. And Jan Pešek is there with another big save.
Yeah, Jan Pešek, he's got to be aware of the top of the net. I think the Tottenham Steam are looking upstairs when they look at Jan Pešek. I'm afraid they think he might be dropping a bit or a bit too soon. That happens sometimes when the goalie gets tired throughout the game. Pešek needs to keep on his feet at all times.
Well, he's definitely not the size of Denny Doublestein, nor is he the size of his backup, Wes Werner.
So, right, Mark, so that's the case. So when a forward flicks his wrist and Pešek hits the ground, there's going to be a foot open above his shoulders. He's got to be careful.
Well, he was the number one goaltender in the regular season, and he must have a way of knowing by Jan Pešek radar where that puck is going, getting that glove up there or the shoulder up there or back up on his haunches to save those pucks. Tottenham working in their own zone. Kotek back to get it as it gets knocked out. Wallace keeps it in, shovels it back to Kotek as he skates across the blue line. Kotek makes the red line, a little hop bounce off the end boards and right into the glove of Denny Doublestein.
8 minutes left in the second period. Tottenham up 2-1. There's the Tottenham bench, just Ryan Wood imploring his charges. You know, again, play smart, boys. Keep discipline. We got a lead here. We want to go back on that bus tonight up, you know, yeah. Up 3-2. Let's play a different game than we did last night.
Yeah. Making the trip back home after 2 games and losing 2 games isn't as good as splitting. So we'll see what happens here. Brandon York, quick pass up. Up to Efimov. Efimov gets a big shot, low shot on net, and Jan Pešek, and a little bit of a snow job by Efimov, and he's going to be told about that really quickly. as Kotek lays the lumber into the snowman.
Yeah, there's a lot of snow in Moscow, Russia, and I guess Efimov's figure Yan Pashik should have some of it.
Well, Marcel Kotek took offense to that. Jan Pešek didn't seem to let it bother him too much, but you have to send that message. You're going to snow the goalie. You're going to pay the price. And there we go. There's a little flick into the bench, another little bit of a message to don't mess with my goaltender.
Yeah, and we just saw a shot a few moments ago, Mark, about the crowd here in Kingsville. Capacity of crowd here again on a Friday night. The fans here love Kingsville Kings hockey.
Brandon York. A little bit of pushing and shoving. He's on the back end as Jan Pešek gets his licks in there as well. You know, someone I haven't seen on the ice since his penalty is Austin Fisher. So I have to keep an eye on that as Axel Kenneth goes in. And there is Austin Fisher right now. First shift back since his penalty up into the netting. And he's throwing the check into Axel Kenneth.
Well, Fisher's a type of player that you want to have out in your own end. He's got size, and he seems physically to be able to handle the likes of Zach Zalkanix and Ludwig Niederbach for sure. But where he's got to excel in his game, Mark, he's got to move his feet and not put his stick on people.
He's got the talent. He just needs to use it tonight. Burdov dumping it in. Back around. Nicholson gets a quick shot. I think that hit Doublestein. He wasn't sure. It might even careened off the post there. Another shot towards the net. Doublestein reaches behind him to make sure he gets it and freezes it against the net.
Yeah, and the common thread I think we see here is the activity around Doublestein for sure. We see Devin Dara back on the ice. Dara's had a tremendous second period for the Kingsville Kings. Whenever he's been on the ice, he really seems to be able to do something to generate opportunities around the steam net.
Well, the Kingsville Kings go for a wholesale line change. Dan Leach is in to take the faceoff. He's got Marvin Simmons and Ivan Hojalov in with him. Havelka and Kotek on the points. Leach wins that handily. Comes back to Simmons. Leach grabs it behind. Little soft pass, little bouncer. Gets another whack at it, but Denny Doublestein holds his ground and comes up with the puck.
That was a great set play as we look at Dan Leach there. Him and Liss and Simmons, they knew exactly what they're doing there, bringing the puck deep below the goal line with every intention of bringing it back out front. Mark, you wait till the opponents come to you, then pop that puck right out front for that scoring opportunity. However, Doublestein got the better of it.
Dan Leach once again wins the faceoff, gets it back to Kotek, and it got a little bit tangled up in his feet, and he shoves it into the corner. Stepan Timofeyev throws the check and lets the puck get out of the zone, and Robert Liss is back. York was chasing him. Back up. It beats Brehm, and now Robert Liss is working him. Timofeyev up to York. It's 2-on-2. York back to Fisher. Fisher with a big shot, and Jan Pešek. That was a great shot. Big wind, low across the ice, and Jan Pešek saw it all the way.
Yeah, Brandon York has been in on both Tottenham goals tonight, and he looks like he wanted to be in on a third one there. A great pass to Fisher, although Jan Pešek standing out on top of that blue ice robs Fisher of that great opportunity.
Looks like York plays a lot of time with Fisher because he had 86 points in the regular season. 53 of those were assists, so he feeds the puck to Matt Fisher quite well, I'm guessing. There's Timofeyev up to Fisher. Fisher, another quick shot. It goes high and wide. What a rocket he can, that little snapper that he has.
They're going high on Pešek,
yep,
Mark.
Just as you said, Steve. There's Vosterik in the far boards. Back to McDonough, over to Zegasy. Zegasy now behind the Tottenham goal. Nicholson is in a foot race with Brendan York. And up into the Kingsville bench.
Both teams look like, Mark, they want to take a better or bigger lead rather in this hockey game. A 2-1 lead in a playoff game of this nature is not much of a lead. It can evaporate at any time. And we've seen it many times so far in this game where a goal can be scored just like that. It doesn't even look like it's time for a goal.
Gardeman in against Johnson. Gardeman goes forward with the puck and knocks it into the Tottenham zone. Puck comes out harmlessly into the slot, and Wallace has the puck. Shovels it over. Kotek gets out of the zone, tries to get it up to Niederbach, and there's a stoppage in play. I think the puck may have gone off one of the players on the bench.
Yeah, you get that with a small rink sometimes. People are hanging over the boards or just resting, waiting for their shift. It hits a glove. The play has to be stopped.
So Canucks and Wallace having words.
Yep.
And making sure he's standing in the right place. And, well, I'm going to stand here because you're standing there. And here, a little stick talk. And Gardeman goes. Interesting that Zolkanics was allowed to take the face off because he was the one that caused it. But nonetheless, Marcel Kotek with the puck in his own zone. Zolkanics pushes his way through Wallace and into the Tottenham zone. Along the boards, Johnson now pushing and shoving on Kotek. Zolkanics is in there working on it as well. And we have a stoppage in play right in front of the Tottenham bench.
Mark, look at those happy fans. Again, a capacity crowd. They enjoy Kingsville Kings hockey. We hope the people at Tottenham all over the Greater Metro Hockey League viewing area are enjoying this game tonight. Game five of this final Russell Cup final. And we know that the fans here are really, really hoping this first-year team can bring that trophy here.
Frederick Surrey shovels it across to Brehm. Brehm goes in deep in the Kingsville zone. Pushed off the puck there by Callum Hofford. And back out of the zone. Oh, Freeman gets it, and Matt Maddie's down there. Danluck has to come back to retrieve. Frederick Surrey one more time. A big shot from way outside the blue line, breaks his stick and goes to the bench for a new twig. Back to Danluck. Shovels it over to defensive partner Brehm, and they get it down to the Kingsville zone. McDonough. Sop back in over to Callum Hofford. And he comes out through the danger zone from behind the net and up the middle of the ice. Shovels into the corner. He's going after it. Brehm's with him. Hofford checks up, makes sure he has good position on Brehm, and gets it, the puck out. There's McDonough. He keeps it in. Working in the corner is Dmitry Danilek. He comes out of the scrum with the puck as Matt Maddie throws the weight into him. Blake Nada plays the pick. Zach McDonough comes up with a puck. Almost tripped up. It's 3-on-2. McDonough with a quick shot. Doublestein has to make a quick save. McDonough back with the puck. Can't quite control it. And here comes Matt Fisher and Brandon York, the tag team of the Tottenham Steam. A little pushing and shoving there. And we got a penalty coming up too. Looks like Johnny Guerrero. He got hit in the face with the stick. And there looks like they might both be going. So Johnny Guerrero got a chop in the face with a stick, and then he grabbed the stick and threw it out of the hand, but I only see the one door open. That's Brandon York, and that's a really interesting call, Steve.
It is. I don't think Brandon York saw that coming. I think he believes he was the recipient of the infraction, and Guerrero was going to go off, but look at that. Obviously, whatever happened didn't fool J.P. St. Jules.
Well, Guerrero definitely grabbed the stick out of York's hand and threw it. So that's at least, you know, unsportsmanlike conduct, maybe holding the stick, but York did commit the offense to start by with the chop in the mouth. And Johnny Guerrero is feeling the pain of that stick, but he got away with one there,
Mark,
in this broadcaster's opinion.
The Kingsville Kings need to score a goal in this power play. They need to tie this up to go into the intermission. They can't allow Tottenham to take this lead into the third period.
3.5 to go here in the second period, and the Steam are pushing shorthanded as Johnson is in there working on four Kings, and he's making sure the puck stays in the Kingsville zone. They can't score from there. Johnson's all over the ice. Ludwig Niederbach down, circles behind the net. Over to Gardeman. Gardeman back to Hofford. Hofford with a big shot and in. Niederbach to Gardeman, and Hofford from the blue line through the crowd and a big collection. And Brandon York is furious.
Yeah, but the Kingsville Kings fans, Mark, look at them. They are so happy. And what did I say? Kingsville needs to get a goal here. There it is. Zach Zolkanic taking his spot in front of that blue ice as they're celebrating this goal, allowing Callum Hofford with that tremendous shot from the point. Doublestein didn't even see it.
Didn't see it. Too much of a crowd there. And great, great execution by the Kingsville Kings on the power play. Berdov comes down across Timofeyev's helmet. with his stick. And Matt Fisher is pushed off the puck. Devin Dara. Efimov now. Native of Moscow. Pushed off the puck. And Nicholson in his own zone to pick up the puck. CJ Nicholson has to sidestep, step on Timofeyev. Both excellent skaters circling around. Icing waved off. Devin Dara in quick. Doublestein is there. Second period, 2-2. 2 minutes, 22 seconds to go. Nothing has been decided in game five of the Russell Cup final. As the Tottenham team come across the blue line, three wide. Kingsville Kings get the stick into place and knock it out of the zone. Fisher dumps it back to neutral ice. Daniel Berdov now meets up with Fisher and dumps it deep. Doublestein doing the work. Shovels it around to the near side. And the puck just squirts out. Here comes Brandon York and Matt Fisher. York just throws a soft shot towards it, and Fisher does get a stick on it as Jan Pešić can't quite control it, but Pešić comes up with the puck, and we'll have a faceoff in the Kingsville Kings zone.
Yeah, I think Kingsville defense here taking exception to the fact that Fisher got a little too tight on Jan Pešić there. Pešić having words now with referee Fedek. Kingsville now in a better position going into this second intermission mark. The team, I really felt the team that scored next has the greatest opportunity to win this game. It's a game of momentum.
Absolutely. Kingsville's got the momentum going now. They just need to find a way to keep it up. Keep the water flowing in the moat. Protect the castle. Kingsville Kings. Zach Steich dumps it into the zone. Blake Nada has it now. Shovels it back. Danluck has to go back into his own zone to get it. Dan Leach pushing him all the way behind the net. Danluck comes up with a puck. Gets it out. Steven Zegesi in his own zone. Picard chasing him. Little stick check, but Steven Zegesi gets the puck back, dumps it into the corner. Gets back on his point. Puck comes right back to him. There's Efimov. Efimov shovels it into the corner. And circles back. 1 minute to go here in the second period, 2-2 hockey game, Kingsville Kings, Tottenham Steam, as Steven Zegesi makes it into the Tottenham zone. He's got Nada and Marvin Simmons with him. Marvin Simmons turns around. He gets knocked down, but he had an opportunity there that he won't get again. Standing in the blue ice, and he could see the puck, but he couldn't get to it. Hofford now, the goal scorer, tied it up, working behind his own net. Great puck position, keeping his opposition away. Still in there. That's Timofeyev and Gardeman with Hofford and Nada. They're working and digging. Timofeyev comes out with it. Gets it back to Danluck. Danluck, a little backhand towards the net. 10 seconds to go. And the puck hops over Surrey's stick and out of the zone. Danluck now has the Tottenham team tag up. Danluck goes deep. He's behind the net. Just over a second. And there's the buzzer. Wow, Steve. Two periods of play, 2-2, game five.
Everything's tied up.
Everything's
Mark.
Tied up. You know, it just continues. No decisions have been made yet.
They say it's this like kissing your sister, and this is what we've seen the whole time. You know, Mark, quickly with the scoring summary, the last goal, rather, to Brandon York's chagrin.
He was angry coming out of the box.
It was Calum Hofford with his seventh of the playoffs, a power play goal with the assist to Niederbach and Zolkanik at 16:57 of the second period, giving the Kingsville Kings a tie in this game five of the Greater Metro Hockey League playoffs.
A much-needed play there for Calum Hofford. Great shot, and the Kingsville Kings find themselves back into this hockey game. There you see it, 2-2. Series tied 2-2. End of the second. Russell Cup Final, Game 5. You're enjoying Kingsville Kings hockey on WeTV. We'll be back.
It's new. It's fresh. It's innovative. It's WeTV, Windsor Essex Television, and you can watch it anywhere. www.we-tv.ca is the place to be. If it's sports, entertainment, or community events, WeTV has what you're looking for. The people, places and faces of our community are front and center on WeTV. Check out www.we-tv.ca for what's being webcast live. We TV, we got you covered.
Tom is trying to justify buying a new car. That should do it.
Need a good reason? There's never been a better time to get yourself into the best-selling car in Canada for 17 years. Now, during the Honda Model Clearout, get a $1,000 Civic bonus when you finance any new 2015 Civic model.
Hi, I'm Joel Quenneville, coach of the Chicago Blackhawks, and a proud graduate of FJ Brennan High. I can remember fondly my 5 great years at Brennan. It seems like just yesterday that we're there. A lot of great life lessons that I learned along the way, particularly from my teachers in the Catholic program. Want to wish everybody there good luck, and look forward to being a proud graduate and being a proud Cardinal going on here in here in Chicago.
Manpower. That's our specialty. We use it to build infrastructure, like the $1 billion parkway. That's real manpower in action. End to end, over 1,000 strong, forming bridges, carving out tunnels, shaping roadways. Our manpower is in demand. Well trained, highly skilled, tough as nails. We've got what it takes to build your career. A solid career for building a better future. LIUNA. Feel the power.
Windsor Essex Sports Connection, WE TV.
Welcome back to Kings Hill Arena. Mark Knight along with Steve Pronger. Do you see the score there after two periods of play? Tottenham Steam 2, Kingsville Kings 2. Steve Pronger, second period was a little bit more to talk about here in the intermission than what we had in the first intermission. Scoring summary, all in the second period.
All in the second period, Mark. Completely blanked out for the first period. Teams feeling each other. Ludwig Niederbach with his 15th of the playoffs. Power play goal from Zolkanic and Zegasi at 1:32 got it started. But it didn't take long for Tottenham to answer. Timofeev, his 22nd. How about that? 22 goals in the playoffs from Daniluk and York at 2:32. Through 2:23, sorry. Tottenham then taking the lead from Brandon York, who got the assist on Timofeev's goal at 5:36. Timofeev assisting on that with Fisher as well. But Kingsville doing what they needed to do to tie this game up to take it into the second intermission. Calum Hofford, his 7th, another Kingsville power play goal from Niederbach and Zolkanic. Mark, Kingsville Kings have scored 2 power play goals. It looks like Tottenham better stay out of the box.
And the penalties were few and far between. Not a lot of penalties, but the Kingsville Kings managed to capitalize on 2 of those opportunities. So kudos to them for getting that done. And you said it perfectly, Steve, that the Tottenham team need to stay out of the box if they're going to stop that. Russell Cup final game scores thus far, 6-5 Tottenham Steam in Kingsville, and then they head to Tottenham for 2 games. Tottenham take one 3-1, and then Kingsville comes back 3-2. Correction, Tottenham takes it 3-2, gets up 2-1 on Kingsville, come back into Kingsville, and the gates open up because the penalty box door opened up on the Tottenham Steam. Kingsville Kings win that game 6-1, and you saw that here on WeTV.
Yeah, the Kingsville Kings in the last 2 games have outscored the Steam 9-3. And really, when we talked about this before the game, just really signals to us, Mark, that the Kingsville Kings just have to keep doing what they're doing. Don't change the game plan. They're getting enough shots in net. They've beat Dubelstein 9 times in the last 2 games. But here we are. We come here tonight, 2 games apiece, and now we're tied again 2-2 after 40 minutes of play.
Next game is Sunday, April 3rd. That's game 6 of the Russell Cup final. That is in Tottenham. Will not be on WeTV, but hopefully all the Kingsville Kings fans and the Tottenham Steam fans will be on the GMHL website following that game. And if necessary, depending on what happens there on Sunday, back here Monday, April the 4th, Kingsville Arena, Tottenham Steam, Kingsville Kings, game 7. As I said, that is if necessary. Steve Pronger will be here. I will be here, and we'll be having that game for you. But before we get to that,
you know where I'll be on Wednesday night, April 16th, Mark?
There you go. Wednesday, April 16th, coming the Windsor Adult Volleyball League. That's a championship day for them. 6:30 p.m. Live on WeTV from St. Clair College Sportsplex. You can see the Kingsville Kings fans cheering for the Windsor Adult Volleyball League in the background. WeTV is going to bring that to you exclusively live on Wednesday, April the 6th. Well, the teams are making their way back to the ice. Steve, what can we expect in the third period?
Well, I think we're going to see a physical affair out here, Mark. Okay, at the same time, both teams are going to be they're going to play a physical game to try to retrieve that puck. It's a puck possession game, but how do you get it? You have to be physical. On the other hand, both teams are going to set a wall in front of their goaltenders. It's the period where you don't touch or you don't come close to my goaltender. If you do, you're going to pay the price. So it's going to be physical, protecting people. Physicalness is going to take away the puck, and
Is that the steam horn? The steam whistle, yeah.
The steam whistle.
Well, we've seen a little bit of blood in the second period as things got ramped up. Can we expect any more of that in the third period?
You know what? I don't think it'll go as far as blood. I don't think either team wants to put themselves in a box, for example, with a major penalty and be down shorthanded for 5 minutes. We see Kingsville have scored on 2 power play goals. We don't want to get to the point of blood. We expect a physical third period.
Well, we'll see what happens, and away we go. Third period it is, and Kingsville Kings, Matthias Gardeman wins that faceoff. Vosterik gets to the red line, dumps it in. And Daniluk goes back, a little bit of a miscue there as Dubelstein comes out to play the puck and Daniluk gets his stick on it. Matt Fisher quickly up to Timofeev. He gets a shot on Jan Pešek and Jan Pešek looks at him and says, I caught that one on you.
Yeah, so right away Tottenham's going to get shots up on Pešek. That hasn't changed from the first drop of the puck. They want to put everything at Jan Pešek. They need to score goals. They didn't get enough shots on net last night. They got to make up for it tonight. They know the recipe to score.
Well, Kingsville Kings didn't like the lineup that they had out there, so they get up to their second line. and Berdov with Devin Dara and C.J. Nicholson, the speedster, in behind his own net. Devin Dara shovels it over to Nicholson, back to Zegasy. Zegasy with a quick shot, that's blocked by Matt Fisher. And he gets up to Brandon York, quickly over to Timofeyev. Back to Fisher, he's in close. And Steven Zegasy gets his stick on that, knocks it up into the corner. We're going to have a face-off in the Kingsville zone.
Both coaches are going to have to coach, Mark, in this period. And what that means is both coaches, Gary Estolos and Ryan Wood, are going to look for that mismatch. They want to get their top line out against the third or fourth line of the other team and take advantage.
Well, Gary Estolos may have a little bit of an advantage there, being he's the home ice, but Kingsville Kings ice the puck, and they're going to try that one more time.
Okay, so you saw Fisher and Timofeyev out for the steam. What does Gary Estolos do? He takes his top line off, puts his second, his checking line out. Now you see Niederbach right back on the ice.
Right back out there with, and Havelka is up tight, and Gardeman with the faceoff. Gardeman wins that and goes forward with it. Niederbach pushes it out but doesn't get it all the way. Picard with a quick shot that's blocked in front by Matthias Gardeman. Gardeman goes into the corner. Fosterik around the near boards. Niederbach gets there, but Walker shovels it back into the corner. Kevin Walker, our WeTV player to watch for the Tottenham Steam, hasn't had as much ice time tonight as he had last night because of all the penalties, but he's definitely a key factor in the Tottenham Steam.
Mark, I'm not counting shots here, but already it's got to be 3, 4, or 5 the Steam have had on Jan Pašek early in this first 2 minutes of the third period. I think we see Ryan Wood's idea here. He's just going to throw. Last night he said kitchen sink hockey. I think he's going to get back to that.
Roll the lines, and we'll see a lot of line matchup, as you mentioned, and Gary Estolos is very aware of what's going on there. Linklater tries to throw the lumber into Zach McDonough. He gets it up on the far boards, and Johnson knocks it back in. Callum Hofford throws it up into Berdov skates. He gets it up to his stick, gets the shot, and Doublestein, they get called for a hand pass.
Good pressure crossing the blue line by Berdov there. Ovchinnikov there, a great shot of him, a huge addition there. Couldn't stop Berdov from getting that shot up on Doublestein. However, defender passing it to his own man. Hodgelof will take this faceoff.
He wins that. Gets it back to Simmons. Simmons cuts it off, throws it into the corner. Ovchinnikov on the far boards, chips it out, and Marvin Simmons has to race back to get it. Chasing him is Trent Linklater, as the Kingsville Kings are giving it back and forth and back, and McDonough gets up off the back of a Tottenham Steam player, and the Kingsville Kings are offside. Having a hard time getting set up here early on in the third period. Just over a couple minutes ago, you see one of the signs there for one of the fans, Go Kings Go. They're really cheering on their team, and they've got lots to cheer about. The Kingsville Kings have done well so far this year.
They love the Kings in this city, Mark. What a great addition to this community.
Fosterik now dumps it deep. Marvin Simmons on the receiving end. Ivan Hodgelov getting pushed off that puck by Austin Fisher. Gets it up to Matt Fisher. Across the blue line, onto the stick of York, and Matt Fisher shoves it behind the net. Had a great opportunity there, but couldn't quite convert. Brehm with a quick shot there, but Jan Pešek gets the pad down, and the Kingsville Kings clear the zone. Danlich behind his own net. Over to York. York back to Brehm, and quickly up. And Johnny Guerrero cuts that off. Drops off to Hojlov. Hojlov with a quick shot through a crowd, but Denny Doublestein is there to make the save.
Matt Fisher of the Tottenham Steam, Mark, is a smart hockey player. He realizes every time he puts up a shot on net, there's going to be a second opportunity. He just doesn't fly by or fly off. He's going for a rebound. We saw that in the second period. Again, Fisher follows the puck after his shot.
Smart hockey players tend to get the most points, and if that's true, then Fisher's one of the smartest players on the Tottenham Steam with 146 points in the regular season, and he's second place in the playoffs thus far with 34 points, only behind Stepan Timofeyev with 44 for the Tottenham Steam. Scrum in the corner. Steam come out of the corner with it. Robert Liss is taking a whack at it, trying to push it off there. And that's Belayev wearing the number 5 jersey of Hahn, and the puck gets knocked up into the girders, and we'll have a face-off in the Kingsville zone.
So you look at both teams. You have a Zalkanik, you have a Niederbach on Kingsville, you have a Fisher, you have a Timofeyev on the steam mark. Who's it going to be? There's a lot of firepower on both teams. We've seen it all season long from both squads, Kingsville in the south, Tottenham in the central. We have 16 minutes left. Who's going to make that difference?
Well, if I had to pick, I would pick Matthias Gardemann for the Kingsville Kings and Brandon York for the Tottenham Steam to put this game up one goal.
I'm writing that down right now.
Write it down. And here we go.
And there it is.
And who gets it? Matthias Gardemann.
I wrote it down, Mark Knight. Wow, the Kingsville Kings crowd for sure.
Look at that.
They're happy about that third goal, and for sure, Mark. Matthias Gardemann from Thunder Bay, Ontario. He is a fan favorite here. He's been that way all year long from the get-go. A great call on that one, Mark Knight. But Kingsville Kings up 3-2. 16 minutes left in this one.
Lots of hockey left. I'm going to put my crystal ball away now. I've used it up. Used all that there is in it. It's
just
empty.
Stop on the way home, Mark, and buy a Lotto Max.
Okay. Actually, I bought one on the way here. Blake Neda over to Devin Dara. Devin Dara on the near boards. He sidesteps his check around from Timofeyev. Still has the puck. Shovels it over and can't quite convert Johnny Guerrero. Timofeyev gets his helmet ripped off. He goes right to the bench. Gary Stalos, the coach, was making sure that the referee saw that, but Timofeyev made it to the bench. We saw a penalty just like that to start the game. Zach Steich. Zegasi in his own zone. Curls and off the glass. Gets it up to Niederbach. Niederbach shovels it in to Doublestein. Easy save. Dmitry Danilek coming out of his own zone. Pavelka quickly gets to it. Back to Danilek. Niederbach pushes him to the ice. As the Tottenham Steam are in the zone, and we've got a penalty coming up to Ludwig Niederbach, likely for holding or interference, one of the two. We'll have to wait and see what Dave Fedek, and he's calling it tripping. Ludwig Niederbach in the box at a very inopportune time of this game.
Yeah, you know, Mark, as called by Mark Knight at 3:51 of the third period, Matthias Gardemann with 10th of the playoff from Ludwig Niederbach and Zach Zalkanik, giving the Kingsville Kings a 3-2 lead. Let's hope for the Kingsville Kings fans' sake that that doesn't disappear on this power play.
Well, here we go. We got a bit of a rush here. Johnny Guerrero on the far boards. He's cut off by Matt Fisher. And Brandon York comes away with the puck. Over to Kevin Walker. Walker across the blue line as the Tottenham Steam set up on the power play in the Kingsville zone. Walker drops it back. You can hear the fans cheering. Lots of Steam fans in the house tonight. There's Picard, a quick shot off of Pešek. He wasn't sure where it was, but he made the save regardless. And down the other end it goes. Brandon York chasing it down. Doublestein throws it up. And a little bit of a miscue. And Havelka has the puck. Havelka one more time throws it down there. Doublestein. No mistake this time, leaves it for Brandon York as C.J. Nicholson curls. All five Steam down below the goal line. Here they come, a wall of five out over the red line. Picard with the puck. Picard with the shot. Jan Pešek shovels it into the corner, makes the save, and very nonchalantly puts it in the corner. Kevin Walker down deep. Timofeyev out to Brandon York. York gets a shot. That's blocked by Dan Leach. And shoveled out by C.J. Nicholson. Nicholson makes the charge to the bench. Blake Nada now. It's Brandon York. Up to Walker. And Nada gets to it first and knocks it back into the zone. 30 seconds left in the penalty to Ludwig Niederbach for tripping. As York comes out of his zone. He's got Kevin Walker on his left. Gets that up to Picard. And now Frederick Surrey is chasing it down. David Vosterik throws it down. He gets it past Dan like he was going to go for a change. The Kingsville Kings are in control of this shorthanded situation at the moment. Blake Nada throwing his weight around on Picard. And now here comes Devin Dara. Big shot. Nice save by Danny Doublestein out at the top of the blue ice. And Devin Dara takes an extra chop from Picard as he skates by. Frederick Surrey now. Up into the zone. The penalty box is empty. Back to 5-on-5. Ludwig Niederbach is on the ice. He's in front of his own net. making sure that no one gets in Jan Pešek's face. And here comes Steven Zegosi. Look, soft throw up into the corner, and that's Brem back in his own zone. Brem knocks it up to Timofeyev. Step on Timofeyev. Up across the red line. He's got Danilek with him. Ovchinnikov hits the brakes on the blue line. In the zone. And Zegosi one more time. He's looking. You got Zolkanics and Niederbach leading the way. Shovels it into the corner. Zolkanics sidesteps that check. And Niederbach behind the net gets it back over to Zolkanics. He makes his way towards the net but can't quite convert. Hojilov throws it in, and that's blocked by Dmitry Danilek. He comes up with the puck and into the Kingsville zone. Got another penalty coming up to Kingsville for a slash. And that's going to go to Zach Zolkanics.
Yeah, Zach better watch it there. He's got to keep the lips tight there. Doesn't want to find himself in the box for 4 or 6 or 10 mark. It's a critical time of the game for the Kingsville Kings. They've just had an excellent, excellent penalty kill there, shutting down the power play opportunity of the Steam, as you see assistant coach drawing something up.
Timeout Tottenham Steam.
Timeout Tottenham Steam for sure. So why not? This is the time. Tottenham has got to have something happen on this man advantage, Mark.
Just over 8 minutes gone here in the third period. The Kingsville Kings lead the Tottenham Steam by a score of 3-2 in Game 5 of the Russell Cup Final. And the Kingsville Kings find themselves down a man to start this next faceoff as Zach Zolkanics is charged with a slashing call. He's making a motion there as the fans are wondering, oh no, we're back on the PK. And they're sending their tweets and they're sending their texts and they're on Instagram and they're on Snapchat and all those things that they do and making sure that everybody knows where they are and they're in the castle watching the Kingsville Kings. Johnny Guerrero in to take the faceoff. Knocks that forward from Picard. Quick shot there as Surrey was fully blocking Jan Pešek, and Jan Pešek let him know about it.
Mark, last night Tottenham might have felt they got the short end of the stick, but they can't complain the opportunities they've had in this third period.
Multiple opportunities thus far, and they just need to find a way to convert. They need to find a way to solve Jan Pešek one more time. Frederick Surrey sidesteps a check from Blake Nada. Still has the puck, drops it back to Picard. Picard winds, shoots, and Jan Pešek is there. And with a little more pushing and shoving. And Colm Hofford makes sure that he clears the drawbridge. He didn't like the fact that Frederick Surrey was right in the cage of Jan Pešek. Jan Pešek let him have it, and Colm Hofford let him have it as well, and they're both going to go to the box.
Yeah, I'm not sure that was a good move by Hofford, although he is taking his Tottenham Steam player with him. Unfortunately, Mark, if this ends up on 4-on-3 hockey, that just gives players like Timofeyev and Fisher more room to work on that power play.
And that's who's on the ice right now. Picard, Fisher, Timofeyev, and Brandon York for the Tottenham Steam. On the ice for the Kingsville Kings, we've got Dan Leach and David Vosterik, and it looks like Steven Zegosi. So Dan Leach, the man up front, he goes forward with it, puts it right on Picard's stick, correction, Fisher's stick. Fisher gets it back. 4-on-3 hockey here for a little bit. A situation that the Kingsville Kings have not been in quite some time. We saw a lot of it the other way the other night as Matt Fisher throws one towards the net, breaks his stick in the process. And now it's 3-on-3 for a short bit as Dan Leach gets his stick under it and gets a soft shot on net. Quickly up to Brandon York. Leach up high. Zegosi and Vosterik on the back as Brandon York comes across the line. Dan Leach. Picard with a quick shot. Fisher comes up with it off the end boards. Timofeyev is floating. Fisher using the screen gets the shot. Jan Pešek with the save, and Steven Zegosi clears the zone as the Kingsville Kings go for a change.
Mark, the Kingsville Kings have to get in shooting lanes here in this 4-on-3 penalty. Have to get in front of these shots.
McDonough and Kotek on right now. Picard with the shot. It bounces off the end boards, and Brandon York puts it home to tie it up 3-3.
Yeah, Brandon York, that's his second of the game, Mark. And
power play goal for the Tottenham Steam.
That was my fear. When I saw Colin Hoffer take that penalty, even though he dragged a Steam player with him to the box, it was going to create too much room in front of Jan Pashuk for the skilled players of the Tottenham Steam. And sure enough, Brandon York with his second of the game.
Well, Jan Pashuk exits the penalty box, and Surrey and Colin Hoffer stay in for the offsetting minors. We're back to 4-on-4, 3-on-3 in the third period. The series tied at 2. And here we go again, Steve. Shall we say it? Nothing has yet been decided.
Nope, nothing is yet to be decided. Mark, we could be in for some extra time here.
Run to the store in the third intermission and get your favorite drink and your favorite snack, because we're going to be here a while, folks. Havelka, quick shot. That one's blocked by Danilek. He comes up with the puck and skates out of his zone. Tottenham's team have got the momentum now. Danilek. Well, with Wallace, gets the quick shot there on Jan Pešić. He steers that to the corner. And Niederbach, soft pass up to Zolkanics. He's looking. He has a bit of a lane. His lane gets closed, and Ovchinnikov comes out. Ovchinnikov puts himself offside, throws it across to Wallace. Steam go for a change, and the Kings come back the other way. Still 4-on-4, Ludwig Niederbach with the puck, and Austin Fisher throws a big check into Niederbach. Niederbach sidesteps Kevin Walker. Puck comes up to Wallace. Across the line, and a big check right in the chest from Marcel Kotek onto Wallace, and Wallace is hurt. Might have caught his wrist in that. Here comes Nicholson. He's trying to get around Austin Fisher, and icing is the call. Big check there on open ice, and you saw Wallace go to the bench. He was in a little bit of pain there on that open ice check.
Mark, the once excited Kingsville fans are a little quiet at the moment. They, you know, anything can happen. I don't think they thought they would find themselves on a tie. They were hopeful the Kings were going to win this hockey game with a fourth, fifth, or sixth goal.
Well, quick shot there behind the net, and not that I want to blow my own steam horn, but I believe I said Brandon York as well.
You did, Mark. You did.
So, quick shout-out to Nicholson. Nicholson behind the net. He's pushed off the puck there by Surrey. Correction, make that Jake Sterrick. Sterrick goes down holding his head. Zegasy up to Burdov. Burdov shoves it over to the open wing. Fisher up to Fisher. Austin to Matt. Matt gets it back. Quick shot over there to Timofeev, and he shovels it wide of the net. Penalty box is empty. Back to 5-on-5 hockey as the Kingsville Kings are in fight mode now, it seems. Like the Tottenham Steam have a little bit of momentum as Burdov comes across the line. He's got Zegasy up in the blue ice as the net gets ridden up. Reset there by the referee, and play goes on. Devendera over to Burdov. Burdov shoves it high. Devendera pulls it down. We got a helmet off. And we may have another penalty. Yes.
Mark, I know this may sound familiar. You see the coach giving the gears to that player. They're right there, Brem. They have to use their head.
Yes.
When that helmet comes off.
For more than something to hold the bucket.
You know what? When that helmet comes off, you know the rule. You're in the league all year. The helmet comes off. You got to get off the ice. You can't stay there. Try to put it on. Play in the game. Referee J.P. St. Jules saw it the second time that's happened to them tonight.
Yeah. Zach Steich got called for it in the first period.
Yeah, you would think I can appreciate the frustration of the esteemed coach there. Now the Kingsville Kings find themselves with an opportunity to take control of this game.
Bit of a momentum shift here, and Steven Zegasy drives one towards the net. Ludwig Niederbach trying to get his stick on it as the Steam dump it out, and you can hear the crowd cheer as they work this penalty kill. Callum Hofford, a goal scorer here tonight. Ludwig Niederbach up across the line. He's pushed off the puck. Frederick Surrey now working it. Niederbach comes up with it. Niederbach gets tripped up. Back to Zegasy. Zegasy keeps it in. Puck goes over to Niederbach. Niederbach tries to hit Gardeman with it, and it's just a little too wide. It's a foot race. Hofford and Surrey. Hofford, good puck position, puts himself between the puck and the player, and comes up with it. Knocks it around to the open end. Step on Timofeev in the corner. And here comes Ivan Hojlov. He's got Hofford on his wing. Zolkanics with him as well. Into the corner. Zolkanics goes after it. Kevin Walker's there. They fight for it. And Nicholson. Back to Hojolov. Dara back on the ice. Hofford now. Quick shot. Goes wide of the net. 46 seconds left in the power play. And Kotek tries to chop it down. All the way down gives the Tottenham's team an opportunity to change. And Matt Fisher blocks that one off. Shovels it over to Timofeyev. He's just burning the clock at the moment now. 30 seconds in the power play. And they're in the Kingsville zone.
The Tottenham's team has been very aggressive on this power, this penalty, playing up ice. They're smothering the Kingsville Kings, Mark.
They haven't had a chance to do much. You're right, Steve. Here's Danlik now. Tries to shovel it out, and it gets past David Vosterik and all the way down to Jan Pešek. One last push here for the Kingsville Kings as they set up. Watching for Brehm to come out of the box. Leach shovels it over. Brehm's out of the box. He's got Picard with him. Brehm with the shot. It goes wide of the net and around to the near side. Lucas Avelka. Over to David Vosterik. Vosterik up the right side. Back in. Picard knocks it deep. And Belayev goes after it. Ovchinnikov calling for icing. And he gets the call.
Mark, there's a great shot of Doublestein. What's he going to do? Is it going to be him or Pašek? Which one of these two is going to step up and win this game? I know Doublestein hopes it's him. Jan Pešek for sure down, wants to get away with a lead going down the road on Sunday to Tottenham. But this next 5 minutes is critical. Someone's got to make a difference. Mark, you've called two players who are going to make a difference. They already have. Both coaches are looking for leadership.
Well, Ryan Wood has definitely shortened his bench now. He's down to two, maybe two and a bit of lines. So if you're not playing, you're on one end of the bench, and we're seeing a lot of that. Walker shovels it in. Kingsville Kings got their third line out there right now. Correction, make that their fourth line. As Gary Stiles keeps running the lines, and we got an offside call on the Tottenham Steam. The Steam have got to be tired. A game like this where you've got your bench so short and it's a must-win situation.
Yeah, for sure. Each player on that bench, Mark, has to be sitting there with 5 minutes left going, I have to make a difference. It's just not time for a shift. It's time for an exceptional shift.
45-second shifts, give it all you got and get back on the bench. There's Belayev having a hard time with the puck. Zolkanics now. Quickly over to Niederbach. Niederbach steps in. He's been in the middle. Split the D. Quick shot. And is turned away. Zolkanics now. Corralling the puck. Trying to get it back out to Niederbach. Niederbach's out front. Gardeman's with him. Puck's bounced off it. And the Steam get it out of the zone. Not pretty, but they get it out of the zone. Here comes Gardeman one more time. A little bit of scuffle. Gardeman looking for the shot. Right into the glove of Denny Doublestein as he flashes the leather, gives him a big target to hit, and Gardeman hit it.
A little bit of rough stuff behind the play there. We see Kingsville changing their lines. You're going to see, as you said, Mark, 30 seconds, 40 seconds, 45 seconds. Gardeman with a great shot in net there. Doublestein with the save. 4 minutes left for someone to make the difference.
Ryan Wood goes back with his top line, and Kingsville's got their third line out there right now. Nicholson, Burdov, and Devin Dara. Devin Dara gets a quick shot on Doublestein, and he holds his ground. Another faceoff to his right.
The remaining time could see him a bit manic for the next 4 minutes. You know, guys are going to try to do what they ever can, whatever they can, to get pucks on net and also try to protect their own net. It could be kind of crazy, Mark.
Gary Estalo still has one timeout to call as CJ Nicholson goes into the corner, fighting for the puck. Hofford now throws it towards the net. And Austin Fisher tries to feed Timofeyev. He gets it over to Matt Fisher, and Timofeyev goes to the net. Fisher's being charged there by McDonough. McDonough doing a great job keeping Fisher off the puck. It gets around to Devin Dara. Devin Dara just wisely flips it up, and Daniel Burdov is in there to pick it up. Burdov shovels it behind him. Still onside. And the puck squirts out. Just gets back McDonough. McDonough comes back, working hard against Picard. Gets over to Fisher. Fisher puts it in the net. Picard to Fisher. The number one line for the Tottenham Steam. And the horn is going.
There it is, Mark, right in front of us. These happy Steam fans made the trip all the way from mid-northern Ontario. They're liking what they've seen. They're up four. Matt Fisher. They're up 4-3 with a goal. Matt Fisher. And can I just quickly say that came after a Brandon York goal from Picard and Hahn at 9:37 that gave Tottenham the tie at 3-3.
Ovchinnikov's line's back on for the Tottenham Steam. And Dan Leach is on there for the Kingsville Kings. Leach across the blue line. He's got a little over 3.5 minutes to tie this game up one more time. Back to the blue line. And the Steam definitely have the momentum now. As Ovchinnikov comes across, he tries the blind pass, but no white sweater in the vicinity. Marvin Simmons up across the blue line. He loses the puck, but Dan Leach comes up, gives it back to Simmons. Simmons in the corner, shovels it over to Leach. He's behind the net. He sidesteps to check off Ovchinnikov back in the corner. Simmons, his lane is closed. Matt Matte throwing his weight around as the Tottenham Steam ice the puck. And we'll have a faceoff down to the left of Danny Doublestein.
So, Mark, you might wonder at this point, if you're Gary Stallus, when do I call that timeout? When and if do I pull that goalie? Each coach now is going to be thinking these kind of things. Even Ryan Wood's going to be thinking, okay, what's Stallus going to do? Is he going to call a timeout, get that faceoff in? Is he going to save it, use it? We'll see what happens. Kingsville, though, has to, Mark, has to. If they want to go down the road and win this series, in Tottenham on Sunday, they got to find that back of the net in less than two or three minutes.
Well, with the speed of the Tottenham Steam, if I were Gary Stallus, I'd be very cautious as to what time I pulled Jan Pešek.
Absolutely.
You really have to play that card at the right moment and make sure you've got the line set up and your right guys rested at the right time. He's got his top line on there right now, so you can bet it's not going to pull him here at the end of their shift. Here comes Zegosi. He throws it in, gets it deep. Doublestein there to play it. Zegosi makes it all the way to the end boards. Stepan Timofeyev shovels it up to Picard. Picard gets around Johnny Guerrero. He's got Fisher with him. Can't quite get it across. David Vosterik with a great block, because Fisher had an open net up to Niederbach. Niederbach's pushed off the puck there by Austin Fisher. Good check. Crowd wanted a penalty there. Shot high. Minute 58 to go. Zach Zolkanek's up across the line. He's got Niederbach with him. Niederbach shoves it to the open wing. He goes after it. Back to Kotek. Kotek gets the shot. It goes off a double stein, and high is the rebound. Kevin Walker knocks it out, and the net is empty. Marcel Kotek is back there to get it.
Okay, Mark, you wondered when Gary Stallus would pull the trigger on that. He did it.
It's happened.
We didn't even notice it. Yep. We were so focused on the other end of the rink.
Great stop there by our player to watch, Lucas Avelka. Back in there playing net as the Kingsville Kings are out there. Nicholson, Zegosi, Hojilov, Havelka. Havelka with a good rising shot up and over the net. Devin Dara is in there now. Just over a minute to go. Hojilov drops it back. Quick shot up. Knocking it around, pushing and shoving as the Tottenham Steam get the puck to the blue line. Havelka shovels it towards the net. It hits a body and goes wide. Hojilov, great shot off a double sign. He didn't know it even hit him. Kotek has to race back. Under a minute to go. 4-3 for the Tottenham Steam. And this pace is manic. And I believe you used that word a little earlier, Steve. Dan Leach, back behind the net. Come out. Tottenham Steam. Backhand shot off the post. Colm Hofford back to get it. A little wobbly. And Dan Leach shovels it into the corner. And icing will be the call here. And the Kings will get an opportunity to change their line, and the Tottenham Steam will not, and they both have to be tired. And this has got to be an advantage for Gary Stallus.
If I was Gary Stallus, I'd line my guys up for the faceoff.
Right now.
Obviously get everyone over there, then call that timeout and bring them back. I can't think he's going to do anything differently.
And there's the call.
I would have lined him up first, give him a little extra break. Mark, I said it, manic. This is what happens. But you know what? This is what hockey fans love to see. They love this kind of manic. Everyone's on their feet here. Everyone's nervous and anxious. Look at the people from Tottenham in front of us. And why shouldn't they be excited? Stuart Carter, our statistician, just handed me this note as we look at Gary Astolis drawing up his play. He's got 21 seconds to execute it. It was Matt Fisher, Mark, at 16:21, giving Tottenham a 4-3 lead unassisted, his 20th of the playoffs.
Well, that puts it really tight there between Stepan Timofeyev, and those two gentlemen for the Tottenham's team have done magic. Matt Fisher is just, and the additional horns are out now. The fans have got the little horns along with the steam whistle that they brought with them. They're having a great time here tonight in the castle as the Kingsville Kings, one last rush, 21.7 seconds on the clock, and Hojlov is in to take the faceoff. Picard drops onto it, just like he thought he would. Zegosi winds, shoots. That's blocked by Matt Fisher. Quick shot towards the net. Fisher comes up with a puck. All he's doing is making sure that he keeps the puck away. Drops on in the corner. We got a quick whistle. 9.4 seconds to go. And another faceoff as Matt Fisher is doing a wonderful job of keeping the Kingsville Kings off the puck.
Absolutely.
The faceoff was exactly like I thought Picard was going to do. He dropped on the faceoff, tried to tie it up and keep control of it. We're going to do it one more time. You're going to watch, and it's likely going to be the same thing. Hojlov, Picard are in there. Niederbach is back in the cannon position. Hojlov's just hoping to pull it back, and Niederbach is going to pull the trigger and try and beat Denny Doublestein to tie this up and send it into overtime. Well, Gord Young's got everybody in the right position, and we'll see what happens. It gets back. Niederbach gets it off the crossbar and up and over.
That's all the Kingsville Kings need, Mark, is one shot in net. They have to be careful they don't have too much traffic in front of the net because you're just blocking the shooting lane, the scoring hole, if you will. Hodgelov's got to win that back. Two or three people need to go to the net, tie up Tottenham's team players. Niederbach, Zolkanic, somebody got to get that shot on net if we want to see overtime here. Looks like Doublestein is taking his time there purposely. You know, he's probably faking some situation, I'm going to guess, just to give people a rest. Why not?
Why not?
Gord Young going to add to it.
Separating out the players. Getting their positions back in there. Matt Fisher, Zach Zolkanic. Back, shot, goal! Colin Hofford! Whoa! Hojlov to Niederbach to Hofford in the net.
Mark,
wow.
Incredible. Colin Hofford, a tremendous blast with 2.7 seconds left from his point. Hojlov wins that drop. Ludwig Niederbach with a heads-up play, Mark. Not taking the shot, realizing there's too much traffic in front of him on this half of the net, shifts it over to Hofford. Hofford driving that puck home, beating Doublestein with 2.7 seconds left, Mark. We are going to overtime to the delight.
I'm sure Denny Doublestein expected Ludwig Niederbach for the shot.
Everybody in the building did.
That was it. That was classic setup executed perfectly.
Mark, you've seen a lot of hockey, and so have I. That play was outstanding. I wish we could bring a replay to our fans, but Ludwig Niederbach with a heads-up play, finding Colin Hofford, who was open. Mark, we're going to overtime.
And here we go. Buzzer goes. Our first overtime game, and the fans are just lit up. This is just...
Wow.
Well, we're gonna be right back here. I gotta catch a breath, Steve. We'll be right back. More WeTV hockey here in Kingsville Arena.
It's new. It's fresh. It's innovative. It's WeTV, Windsor Essex Television, and you can watch it anywhere. www.we-tv.ca is the place to be. If it's sports, entertainment, or community events, WeTV has what you're looking for. The people, places and faces of our community are front and center on WeTV. Check out www.we-tv.ca for what's being webcast live. WeTV, we got you covered. Tom is trying to justify buying a new car. That should do it.
Need a good reason? There's never been a better time to get yourself into the best-selling car in Canada for 17 years. Now during the Honda Model Clearout, get a $1,000 Civic bonus.
Welcome back to King's Hill Arena. Overtime here at the Castle. 4-4 on the shot by Colin Hofford. And we got 5 minutes of sudden death overtime as the Tottenham team come into the Kingsville zone. Matt Fisher is offside.
Okay, what a game this was. 16-21 of the third period mark. Matt Fisher, his 20th of the playoffs, put the Tottenham team up 4-3. And you saw it with 2.7 seconds 19. Left. It was Calum Hofford tying this hockey game up and throwing it into overtime.
19-57. Boy, it doesn't get any tighter than that. In basketball, they call that a buzzer beater. Working in their own zone. Kingsville Kings. Get it up to C.J. Nicholson. He's got to get past Kevin Walker. Devin Dara now. Working the puck. He shovels it forward. He comes in. All by himself. Shoots wide. And Vosterik beats the puck to the blue line and keeps it in. Devin Dara working on it. Knocking it down. Dan Leach now in there. Picard now with the puck. The face-off guru of the Tottenham Steam. Dan Leach pushing on him. Frederick Surrey shoves it over to an open wing. And David Vosterik gets it up to Matthias Gardeman. Gardeman with an easy shot in on Doublestein. Doublestein makes the save.
Going back to that goal for the Kingsville Kings, bringing us here into overtime, most people, most players are going to take that shot. They're look. I got 3 seconds. I got to put something up. Credit to Ludwig Niederbach, Mark, who had the presence of mind to send it over to his open teammate. Hofford had half an open net, and he put it in.
On his stick, about an eighth of a second, and well executed. Tottenham Steam, Zach Steich. Quick shot there on Jan Pešek. Jan Pešek was looking. He had it, but he didn't know that he had it. He thought it might have squirted by. That's always a sickly feeling.
So for our viewers at home, Mark, can you quickly explain the overtime? You were here for the first game.
In the GMHL, overtime here in the finals is 5 minutes sudden death, and then we go directly to a shootout. So for those of you that aren't familiar with that, that may not have been watching our first game, those are the rules here in the GMHL. So that's where we are now, 3:26 to go in the 5 minutes sudden death. C.J. Nicholson tries to step around. Jake Sterrett. Knocked back in there by Marcel Kotek. And the puck gets back into the Kingsville zone.
Mark, this is why you got to love the game of hockey. Anything can happen at any time, right?
Lucas Havelka. Absolutely. Havelka's got Niederbach with him. He comes up. He's going all the way. And he's called on the offside. Niederbach lifted the wrong foot at the wrong time and put Lucas Havelka.
Mark, over the course of hockey, whether it's pro or junior or college, how many people have left a hockey game early? When they, right?
I can't count, but I know a few. I've always been one of those people, you go to the movies, I stay to the last credits. I stay to the hockey game. I think I've left one hockey game early in my life. Steven Zegesi tries to split the D. Zach Steich comes up with the puck. That's Niederbach working with Steich. Surrey shovels it over to Danlock. He's behind his own net. In behind Doublestein. He works it out. Back up to Surrey. Surrey shoots wide. Steich over to Danlock. Danlock tries to cycle behind Jan Pešek. He comes out with a curl. Throws one on the pads. And here comes Colin Hofford. He's got Zolkanics with him. Zolkanics is in. He gets checked. Tries to get it back to Gardeman. He can't quite get to it. Dmitry Danlock has Gardeman's stick tied up. And the Tottenham Steam get to the red line, and they're called for icing. As Frederick Surrey is arguing with the linesman, saying, no, I made the red line, but you're not going to get the referee to change his call.
No,
icing
no.
On the Tottenham Steam.
Dave Fedek, explain it to him right now. There's the Kingsville bench. Wow, what a lift. You know, what Kingsville needs to do is get as many shots on Doublestein as they can. He's a bit deflated after giving up that late goal, and Kingsville can really exploit him and his mental attitude with a few quick shots on net.
Quick shot there. Doublestein didn't play that very cleanly. Gardeman is just a little upset with himself. He said he could have had a better shot there. Here comes Matt Fisher. He's across the blue line. He's got Timofeyev with him. Devin Dare is looking for the gravy pass. He gets it. Can't quite control it there as Kevin Walker comes down. Dare hits the brakes and falls. Here comes Kevin Walker. On the end of his shift, he's out of gas. Minute 26 to go here in overtime. Score tied at 4. Series tied at 2. We're in game 5 of the Russell Cup final. Here comes Marcel Kotek. He's across the line. He shovels one over there. Kevin Walker shoved to the boards by Zolkanics. Matt Fisher takes a half a check by Devin Dara and shovels the puck off. Puck gets over to Daniluk. Last minute of play here in overtime. As the Kingsville Kings get across the zone. Zach Zolkanics throws one up there. That's blocked by Timofeyev all the way back down to the Kingsville zone. Vosterik. Stretch pass up to the Zolkanics. He catches it. He's onside. He's checked off the puck by Zach Steich. Steich gets over to Picard. Picard up across the line. Gets the shot. That's blocked. Another gets it back, gets a shot, and it goes wide. 30 seconds to go. Icing is called on the Kingsville Kings. Wow.
Regardless, Mark, of the outcome of this game, there is going to be a game 6.
There is going to be a game 6, and that's in Tottenham. And
wow. Sunday night, 5:30. Boy, what an excited crowd in Tottenham.
I wonder how many Kingsville Kings fans will make it to Tottenham. Quick shot up, and I thought that went off the netting, but they're playing it. David Vosterik. Up to Nicholson. Nicholson shoving it around. Dan Leach now. He's got 10 seconds to go. Dan Leach is being attacked by Daniluk. Kevin Walker now. Hopped off Chinnikov as the buzzer goes. And that'll wrap up the 5 minutes of overtime. We're going to have a short break here as the teams get set up for the shootout portion of tonight's game.
Wow.
Thanks for staying with us, folks, here on WeTV. We're really glad that you've enjoyed this game as much as Steve and I can only assume that you've enjoyed this game, Steve. But it's just been a great, great game all the way around.
Mark, sometimes I think I'm too old to watch hockey games like this. You know, the it's not the garden-type variety. It goes down to the wire. The Tottenham Steam, they think their fans are cheering right in front of us. They think they're going to go home with a win. They can't believe it. The Kingsville Kings fans are sitting here, capacity crowd. Their shoulders are sloped. Then Kingsville scores. It's been so back and forth. What an emotional game. And now it's going to be settled by breakaway shots. The famous shootout, love it or hate it, we're at that point.
Yeah.
Soccer, penalty shots, yeah. Hockey, the shootout, we're here. One of these two teams in 5 or 10 minutes, Mark, is going to be up in this series 3-2.
Well, Coach Gary Estalos has chosen to shoot second. So the J.P. St. Jules did indicate to the Tottenham Steam that they go first. But we need a goaltender for the Kingsville Kings. And the Tottenham Steam have chosen to start off with number 22, Stepan Timofeyev. Great hands, great speed, great moves against Jan Pešek, one of the best goaltenders in the GMHL. The other night, we went to overtime and we went to shootout, and the Tottenham Steam were the victors 6-5. We'll see what happens tonight. Timofeyev now. He goes in across the blue line. Fakes, nice poke check there by Jan Pešek, and he's pumped.
Yeah, he's happy about that one for sure. And look at the fans here in Kingsville. The horns are out. They're excited. It's a Friday night hockey, Kingsville Kings. And look at, here's
the defenseman.
And who is it?
Kalmhoffard.
Yeah, the goal scorer to tie this game up and bring us to here, Kalmhoffard.
And he's got a look on his face. Gets to the slot, moves, and he just runs out of ice. And the Steam fans are enjoying that. A little bit of a miscue, couldn't quite get the puck to settle down, and that's what happens at this point of the game. Matt Fisher, the leading scorer of the GMHL with 146 points in the regular season, is now up to the challenge. Can he bring the Tottenham Steam that much closer to victory tonight. Matt Fisher, up across the blue line. Head fake, quick shot. Jan Pešek is there. He's pumped. He's geeked. Look at him. He's just, you don't often see goaltenders get that excited in a shootout, but Jan Pešek is just over the moon.
Now, Mark, here's a surprise coming out for the Kingsville Kings, I have to say.
Daniel Berdov,
he must be doing things in practice that impress his coach, because not often you see a defenseman made winger.
I'm going to expect him to get to the blue line and rip one here. He's going to go. And he tries it and just, yeah, I got to agree with you, Steve. I don't know if that was the right decision by Gary DeStalos.
I don't know, Mark. You have Zolkanek, Niederbach, Hodgelov all with 20-plus points in the playoffs.
And Tottenham's team are going with their big three. Timofeyev, Fisher, and Picard now. And the other two have been unsuccessful. Here's number 25 going in on Jan Pešek. And Jan Pešek gets pulled out of the net, and Picard puts one in. So now the pressure is on the Kingsville Kings.
They got to score here.
Picard with the move, and now Marvin Simmons. Now I really don't understand.
Okay, well, Marvin Simmons, Arizona-born player. Here he is, Mark.
Wow. Okay. I'm without words, Steve.
I don't know what to say. Niederbach, Gardeman, Zolkanek on the bench, Hodgelov.
Leach. Wow. Nada.
Well,
Maddie.
Here you go, Mark. Game.
Nicholson.
Game six, Sunday night. Kingsville Kings now are going to have to win two more to win the Russell Cup final. If they're going to win this thing, we will be back here on Monday night for Game 7, because Kingsville Kings need two now. Tottenham can wrap it up in their own building on Sunday night.
Well, we want to say thanks to all the folks in Tottenham for enjoying the game here on WE TV. Steve, who do you have as your three stars tonight?
Well, I think the first star of the game clearly goes to Matt Fisher, goal scorer, leading goal scorer for the Tottenham team from Barrie, Ontario. I'm still kind of reeling a bit over that thing. Our second star of the game would be Brandon York from Barrie, Ontario, from the Tottenham team as well. And with our third star of the game, Ludwig Niederbach from the Kingsville Kings. 1, 2, 3. Two Tottenham Steam players deserving first and second star of this game, Mark, I'm afraid.
Well, and the Steam came in this building to win, and they fought and they fought and they fought, and they, in the end, they were successful. But you have to ask, and you see Zach Zolkanek's and Brandon York chatting there at the slot, and they're just having a chat, nice friendly chat, and what's going on. You have to question the decision of the coaching staff of the Kingsville Kings for sending out the three players that he sent. Colm Hofford, yes. Colm Hofford's been is a hot stick. But, you know, Marvin Simmons?
It appeared to be a good move that Gary DeStalos called his timeout, set up the play. They scored the goal to get them in overtime. But I have to say, you saw the three big shooters for Tottenham come out, one of them York scoring the goal. That was actually his second goal or third goal of the night. Kingsville Kings, I think they just let one slip away from the here, Mark. They're going to have to win two on the road now to wrap this up. I don't know what to say either, but you know what I do want to say? I want to thank all the viewers for joining us here on this broadcast tonight on WE TV. We may see them back here Monday night at the Kingsville Arena. Game time to be announced.
Well, the pressure's on. You can see the look on Zach Zolkanek's face. He's just wondering what happened. How did they let it slip away, as the Tottenham Steam are cheering their boys on, and rightfully so, because they've earned this win tonight. They have played hard, and the Kingsville Kings are wondering what happened. But there you go. Monday night is our next potential broadcast. Game 7, if necessary. The Tottenham Steam make the trip south back into Kingsville as they head to the castle if Game 7 is allowed. So the Kingsville Kings need to find a way to solve the Tottenham Steam, Denny Doublestein, Ryan Wood, and the rest of the squad in Tottenham to come back here. There's the final score tonight. Tottenham Steam 5, the Kingsville Kings 4. Tottenham lead the best of seven series by a score of 3-2 via a shootout final. From everybody here at WE TV, Mark Knight, Steve Pronger, thanks for being here, and we'll hopefully see you soon. Good night.